Lambert, please. Looking to her. Yes. Yeah. Face. Just a little bit. Yeah, like that. Yep, that's good.
ദുഃഖത്തിൻ്റെ പാനപാത്രം കർത്താവിൻ്റെ കയ്യിൽ തന്നാൽ സന്തോഷത്തോടതു വാങ്ങി ഹല്ലേലൂയ പാടിയിടും ഞാൻ. ദുഃഖത്തിൻ്റെ പാനപാത്രം കർത്താവിൻ്റെ കയ്യിൽ തന്നാൽ സന്തോഷത്തോടതു വാങ്ങി ഹല്ലേലൂയ പാടിയിടും ഞാൻ. ദോഷമായിട്ടൊന്നുമെന്നോടെ താതൻ ചെയ്യുകയില്ല, എന്നെ അവനടിച്ചാലും അവൻ എന്നെ സ്നേഹിക്കുന്നു. കഷ്ടനഷ്ടം ഏറി വന്നാൽ ഭാഗ്യവാനായി തീരുന്നു ഞാൻ. കഷ്ടമേറ്റ കർത്താവോടൂ കൂത്താളിയായി തീരുന്നു ഞാൻ. സൗഖ്യമെന്തു തരും ആത്മക്ലേശമതിന് ഫലം, സൗഭാഗ്യമുള്ള ആത്മജീവൻ കഷ്ടതയാൽ വർദ്ധിക്കുന്നു. ജീവനത്തിൻ വമ്പു വേണ്ട, കാഴ്ചയുടെ ശോഭ വേണ്ട, കൂടാരത്തിൻ മൂടി പോലെ ക്രൂശിൻ നീണം മാത്രം മതി. പ്രാകാരത്തിലെൻ്റെ മുൻപിൽ യേശുവിനെ കാണുന്നു ഞാൻ. യാഗപീഠമവനത്രേ എന്നും എൻ്റെ രക്ഷയവൻ, ദിനം തോറും പുതുക്കുന്ന ശക്തി ശക്തി എന്നിൽ പകരുവാൻ സ്വച്ഛജലം വെച്ചിട്ടുള്ള പിച്ചള ഞാനോർക്കുന്നില്ല കഷ്ടനഷ്ടമോർക്കുന്നില്ല എപ്പോൾ എന്റെ കർത്താവിനെ ഒന്നു കാണാമെന്നേയുള്ളൂ ദുഃഖത്തിൻ്റെ പാനപാത്രം കർത്താവിൻ്റെ കയ്യിൽ തന്നാൽ സന്തോഷത്തോടതു വാങ്ങി ഹല്ലേലൂയ പാടിയിടും ഞാൻ
Psalms 34:18 we read, the Lord is close to the brokenhearted and he rescues those whose spirits are crushed. This morning that we have come together in this fashion, the purpose is to bid the farewell to the mortal body of our loving sister, Missy Burgess. As we start the service, let's look to the Lord for a word of prayer and for his blessings this morning. Holy gracious Father, we thank thee and praise thee for this solemn and blessed morning that you've given us. For us to come together as family and assembly as the body of Christ in this county, in New York, and along with our dear ones in India and other places where they are viewing this. We pray that your blessings will be on this service as we are going to say farewell to our sister Lissy today. This is a temporary farewell only because we are just saying fully farewell to her body, for we know that she is with you today and that's the hope and glory and the peace we have. Lord, we look to you for the blessings of this meeting. We pray that the Holy Spirit will take control of every word, every thought, but more importantly, the Holy Spirit will give us the peace and the comfort, especially for the family who's grieving and they need your comfort. So Lord, we pray and commit the service of the throne of grace. We pray that everything will be done in a blessed way that brings glory to you and comfort to the grieving. Lord, we look to you for blessings and we ask for all of these. In the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, amen. This time we will have singing by your choir. blessed songs that reminds us of the wonderful hope and peace that we have in Lord Jesus Christ. This order of today's service is that we're going to have Brother Monish, John Matthews, Brother Monish is going to come and open this meeting in prayer. Today, most of the time is given to the family, or to reflections from the family. Then we'll have the scripture reading and also the message from Brother John, Johnson John, who's also going to be officiating today's service. So let's also put our servant of God in the throne of grace and the Holy Spirit and give him all the anointing that's required for the blessed service today. So this time I ask Brother John Matthew to come forward and approve the service in the throne of grace.
മീറ്റിംഗ് ഇതേ അനുഗ്രഹത്തിനായിട്ട് സർവീസിൻ്റെ അനുഗ്രഹത്തിനായിട്ട് നമുക്ക് ഗുരുവനായ ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ മുമ്പിലേക്ക് നോക്കാം. ഞങ്ങളുടെ ദൈവമേ സ്വർഗീയ പിതാവേ, ഈ രാവിലെ സമയത്തിനായിട്ട് ഞങ്ങൾ നിന്നെ സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു, സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. വളരെ ഹൃദയഭാരത്തോടും ഹൃദയവേദനയോടും കൂടാണ് അടിയങ്ങൾ അവിടുത്തെ സന്നിധിയിലേക്ക് കടന്നു വരുവാൻ തക്കോണം ഇടയായി തീർന്നത്. അതിൻ്റെ ഉദ്ദേശങ്ങളും ആഗ്രഹങ്ങളും ആവശ്യങ്ങളൊക്കെയും ഭർത്താവെ അവിടെ നിന്നുമേ അറിയുമായിരിക്കാൻ സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. കർത്താവെ, പ്രത്യേകാൽ പ്രിയ ലിസി സഹോദരിക്കായിട്ട് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. കഴിഞ്ഞ 61 വർഷക്കാലം കർത്താവെ, ഈ ലോകത്തിൽ വിശ്വസ്ത ഭാര്യയായിട്ട് മാതാവായിട്ട് സഹോദരിയായിട്ട് ജീവിച്ചിരിക്കാൻ ആവശ്യമായിട്ടുള്ള എല്ലാ കൃപയും ഉയരത്തിൽ നിന്ന് അവിടുന്ന് ദാനമായിട്ട് കൊടുത്തു, സഹായിച്ച് കർത്താവെ. ഇത്രത്തോളം നീ അവിടുന്ന് അനുഗ്രഹിച്ചു. കുടുംബമായിട്ട് കർത്താവെ പ്രിയപ്പെട്ട ഒരുമിച്ച് സന്തോഷിപ്പാൻ അവിടുന്ന് ഇടയാക്കിയ സമയത്തിനായിട്ട് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. എന്നാൽ കർത്താവെ, ഈ സമയം അവിടുത്തെ സമയത്ത് കർത്താവെ പ്രിയദാസിയെ അവിടുത്തെ സന്നിധിയിലേക്ക് വിളിച്ച് വേർതിരിച്ച കർത്താവെ അവിടുത്തെ ദയക്കാട് സ്തോത്രം. ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് അതിൽ കർത്താവെ പരിചയപ്പെടാനോ കർത്താവെ പ്രയാസപ്പെടുവാനോ അവിടുത്തേക്ക് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ചെയ്യുവാനോ ഒന്നും അവകാശമില്ല കർത്താവെ. അവിടുന്ന് ആഗ്രഹിക്കുന്ന സമയത്ത് തൻ്റെ വിശുദ്ധന്മാരെ അവിടുത്തെ സന്നിധിയിലേക്ക് ചേർക്കുന്നു കർത്താവെ. അത് ഞങ്ങൾ സന്തോഷത്തോടുകൂടി അത് സ്വീകരിക്കുകയും കർത്താവെ, എന്നാൽ ദുഃഖത്തിലിരിക്കുന്ന മാതാവിനെയും പ്രിയദാസനെയും കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളെയും സഹോദരി സഹോദരന്മാരെയും ഈ സമയത്ത് അവിടുത്തെ സന്നിധിയിൽ വെച്ച് അടിയങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുകയും അവർക്ക് ആവശ്യമായിട്ടുള്ള കർത്താവെ എല്ലാ സമാധാനവും കർത്താവെ പ്രത്യാശയും ആ ഹൃദയത്തിൻ്റെ കർത്താവെ വേദനകളൊക്കെയും അവിടുന്ന് നന്നായി അറിഞ്ഞ് കർത്താവെ, അതിൽ നിന്നൊക്കെയുള്ള പ്രയാസങ്ങളിൽ നിന്ന് അവിടുന്ന് എല്ലാ വിഷമങ്ങളിൽ നിന്നും അവിടുന്ന് സഹായിക്കണമേ എന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. ഈ സർവീസിൻ്റെ ആദ്യോടന്തം കർത്താവെ നീ അവിടുന്ന് സഹായിക്കുകയും എത്രത്തോളം അനുഗ്രഹമായിട്ട് കർത്താവെ പ്രിയദാസിക്കൊരു യാത്രയയപ്പ് നൽകുവാൻ തക്കോണം കർത്താവെ നീ പ്രസാദിച്ചല്ലോ. ഇന്നലത്തെ സർവീസും അനുഗ്രഹമായിട്ട് നടപ്പാൻ അവിടുന്ന് ഇടയാക്കി കുറിപ്പിക്കാനായിട്ട് സ്തോത്രം. ദേശത്തിൻ്റെ വിവിധ ഭാഗങ്ങളിൽ നിന്ന് കർത്താവെ പ്രിയ സൗര സോരന്മാർക്ക് കർത്താവെ എല്ലാവർക്കും ഒരുമിച്ച് ഈ രാവിലെ സമയം അവിടുത്തെ മുഖത്തേക്ക് നോക്കുവാൻ തക്കോണം തന്ന സമയത്തിനായിട്ട് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു കർത്താവെ. അവിടുന്ന് ഒരു മനുഷ്യൻ്റെ ആയുസ് 70 ഏറെയായാലും 80 സംവത്സരം അത് പ്രതാപവും പ്രയാസവും ദുഃഖം അത്രേ, അത് വേഗം തീരുകയും ഞങ്ങൾ പറന്ന് അവിടുത്തെ സന്നിധിയിലായിരിക്കുകയും ചെയ്യും. ആ വലിയ പ്രത്യാശയിൽ കർത്താവെ നീ ഞങ്ങളുടെ ഹൃദയങ്ങളെ അവിടുന്ന് നിറയ്ക്കുന്നതിലോ അതിനായിട്ട് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു കർത്താവെ. എല്ലാ കൃപയാലും അവിടുത്തെ സാന്നിധ്യത്താലും അടിയങ്ങളെ അവിടുന്ന് സഹായിക്കണമേ കർത്താവെ. ദാനിയൽ പ്രവചനങ്ങൾ വായിക്കുന്ന പ്രകാരം കർത്താവെ ദാനിയലെ നീ പോയി വിശ്രമിച്ചു കൊടുക്കുക. കാലാവസാനത്തിങ്കിൽ നിങ്ങളുടെ ഓഹരി പ്രാപിപ്പാനായിട്ട് നീ എഴുന്നേറ്റ് വരുമെന്നുള്ള ആ വലിയ പ്രത്യാശയിൽ പ്രിയദാസിയും കർത്താവെ ആ വലിയ ആ പ്രത്യാശയിൽ അവിടുത്തെ വരവെങ്കിൽ നിൻ്റെ ദാസിയും കർത്താവെ അവിടുത്തെ സന്നിധിയിലായിരിക്കും ഞങ്ങൾ ജീവനോടെ ശേഷിക്കുന്നുവെങ്കിൽ കർത്താവെ ഞങ്ങൾക്കും അവിടുത്തെ സന്നിയിൽ ദാസിയോടും പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവരോടും ഒരുമിച്ച് കർത്താവെ സന്തോഷിപ്പാനുള്ള സമയം ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ദാനമായിട്ട് തരും. ആ പ്രത്യാശയിൽ അടിയങ്ങൾ ഈ പകൽക്കാലത്ത് വളരെ ഭക്തിയോടും ഭയത്തോടും കൂടെ ആയിരിക്കാൻ തക്കണം അടിയങ്ങളെ സഹായിക്കണമേ. എല്ലാത്തിലും അവിടുത്തെ സാന്നിധ്യം ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു മാനവമോഹത്തോടത്തേക്ക് ഇരിക്കട്ടെ. ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ആ ജീവൻ യേശുവിൻ്റെ വിലയേറിയ നാമത്തിൽ താഴ്മയിൽ അപേക്ഷിക്കുന്നു, കേൾക്കുമാറാകണമേ. ആമീൻ.
We request at this time Brother Ben Matthew to come and give us for the reading of the Holy Scriptures, reminding us of the blessed hope that we have in Christ Jesus.
For, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 through 18. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words.
Thank you, Ben. We are definitely in the presence of the Lord, and the body of Christ around this world is viewing and watching us because they are also grieved and they are also praying for the family, and they all loved Sister Lissy. This is the time for reflection, but before the family comes, I would like to give some of the announcements that we have received. Reggie and family from Dubai, they're part of the Maniat family, and also Sergeant and family from Bahrain, from Maniat family, and John Thomas and family from Dallas, and Amini and family from Dubai, they're part of the Nilath family. These are families, they love the sister and the family, and they are also passing their condolences, and they're also remembering you in their prayers. The next order is the family is going to be coming and giving the reflection, but before they come, Sister Lissy was, and her family is part of the RBA family. So before their blood family comes in on behalf of the Rockland Believers Assembly, I just want to give certain reflections on very briefly. They came here in 2004, and we've been worshiping with them as one spiritual family for the last 17 years. I still remember they coming as a young family with very small children to a brand new country, and for them to settle and raise a family and go through all of that was great difficulty they went through, financial adjustments and cultures, all of that. And through all of that, the Lord has been good to them and sustaining them. You know, if someone were to ask me, like, how would I describe Sister Lissy? It's many words can describe, and yesterday even many of our dear ones spoke about those wonderful words. But I know that a lot of the relatives in India, especially Amachi, is listening to my words, though I may not be able to speak in Malayalam. Hopefully somebody will translate to her soon. But she comes from a legacy of a family that loves the Lord, loves his people, and one of the things that they have a very particularity is that the considerations that they have for the children of God. They look upon others first before they even consider themselves. They are a significant part of the Rockland Believers Assembly, and that particular temperament of love and compassion, hospitality and care, and the love of the Lord and his word has been, I would say, not to praise our assembly, but that has been integrated into the DNA of itself, of RBA. And through our Sister Lissy, we could always see that every Sunday and every meetings, every picnics, every retreats that we went. There are many days of wonderful blessings and joys and joyous times that we had together. In all of that, she had that smile, as many had said. She was a person of happy disposition. I know that her life was not easy. She was going through many difficulties. But in spite of all of that, she had a smile and a joy in the Lord. That's the reason I would describe that. But I will also describe her as someone who has raised godly and kind children. And we can see from the fruits of the three children that she was responsible when she was on this world. Joel and Justin,
and Jinsi. You know, the way they interact with us, the way they interact with the community, you could see the goodness of her coming through those children, and that is the fruits that we can see. She loved her family, extended family, and the RBA family very much. From a worldly perspective, if I were to say, she was not a woman that had a lot of position or wealth or clout in this world, as the world would see that as some value. But she relied, as we heard yesterday, she relied on the Lord on a daily basis, as Auntie said, three times she used to pray. That was her currency that she had in this world. The blessings that she got from the Lord Jesus Christ on a daily basis to sustain their needs of the family. And that's what she used on a daily basis. Even we as believers, sometimes we are ignorant, or we never follow through that, or we are not even aware that we have this wonderful blessing. So from that perspective, she was rich in Christ. She had a heart of gold that didn't come from this world, that came from the Lord Jesus Christ himself. So this is the legacy of her family. This is the family that she grew into, and this is what she practiced on a daily basis. We at RBA truly misses her. We will miss the chair that she used to come and occupy, her smile, her concerns. And as one of the brothers said, even within my family, if one of my children were missing on a particular Sunday, she would come and immediately ask us, where is he? You know, what happened to him? So her eyes were on all the members, making sure that the welfare of the members were there. So this kindness, this care is something that we would definitely miss. But we can see that it is shown through her children, and we are blessed because she was part of our assembly for about 17 years, and we were truly missed, and we all will miss her. And even for her family, we are there for you. We are an extension of your family. RBA will never leave you, and you can always rely on the local assembly that for your comfort and your care, so you're never alone. And that is something that I can truly say, because we have been praying for her. But it is the Lord's desire that she has to be with him. And we submit that to the Lord. And we thank you for her life. And we thank you on behalf of RBA for all the blessings and all the things that you have done for us. And it was truly a blessed time when you were in this world with us. At this time, I would ask the family members to come in. And the order is Lissy had six siblings, three brothers and three sisters. The order is, first is Abraham Matthew Raju is going to come and speak, and then is going to be Jacob Abraham and their family, and then Saji, and then Sally and Abraham Philip will come and speak, and then Joji and Suja, and then Daisy and Saji Charian. This is the order that they're going to be going through, and they said that they'll be taking about 30 minutes as they're going to be bringing their reflections.
Praise be to God. As you have heard, I am the elder brother of Sister Lissy. And because I left home at a very early days of my life, my association with her or connection with her was very limited. Then even after coming here, she came to New York in 2004, but I was in Texas as a result. I was not able to improve that relationship just like my other siblings. When I heard about her sickness 3 months ago, I realized the difficulty she is going to face, because my knowledge about this particular situation, I knew the hardness the difficulty of the treatment. And one of my close friend in Houston, late Johnson, Sanguti Pilipos, I saw the difficulty he went through. And I had another friend in my local assembly in Dallas now, who lost his wife even after going through all the treatment. I realized that it's not going to be an easy time. But then I called my daughter, and she said, "Dad, things have changed. There are some hope and some medicines available." And I prayed to God, and I also asked my siblings and my friends and my local assembly in Dallas to pray for her. We earnestly prayed. After 2-3 weeks into the treatment, or after the first course of the treatment, I was told that did not make any difference in her. Then I prayed to God again, "Father, whatever is thy will, it's okay. We will take it as it is." Then I was told that they're going to try another set of chemo on her. And later on, sometime towards the middle of June, I was told even that is not going to make much difference, and they are running out of the option of treatment. I again earnestly prayed to God, but God gave me a peace of mind and a comfort in certain matters. As you all know, my siblings here was very busy with another event, and I was very much concerned as to how things will turn. But I prayed to God, "Father, it is my earnest desire for me to go there and see her and pray with her." And I prayed for that, and God granted that wish. I came here on last Wednesday. I went to see her on Thursday. I prayed with her, had a little conversation. She inquired about a couple of things. And I came back and I told my wife, things are not going to go good even at this point. But the good Lord has moved her from that particular Monty hospital to a nearby comfort care facility. And the event on Saturday went without any disturbance. And on Sunday, the good Lord pleased to take her with him. That's the event which has led up to this point. And it's very hard for all of us to totally comprehend within the three-month span things have turned like this. But I know one thing. As we read in Romans chapter 8, verse 28, "And we know that God causes all things to work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose." This is an easy statement, and everybody likes this statement. Sometimes we embrace all the good things based on this statement with both hands raised. But sometimes this pill is very hard to swallow. But It is true. Our God is a good God. He does everything good according to His plan and purpose for the glory of His name. There is no question about that. He is our comfort. He is our refuge. He is our strength in all situations. Is it true? Yes. Do we have experience? Yes. We have, in our own life, we have experience. And when we look at the life of David, in 1 Samuel chapter 30, we see another statement there, another verse there. David was greatly distressed, and the team or the people with him was very upset, and they were planning to stone him. We know the story, background and all that. They lost their children. Some of them lost their wives. And all these things made them embitter, and they were ready to stone David. But we see one statement there. But David finds strength in himself in the Lord his God. In every situation, we can only find strength and comfort in the Lord. The world will not give any peace. The world will not give any comfort. But in all circumstances, at every time, we can go to God and find comfort and strength in Him. At this point, the good Lord is giving us strength and comfort and peace to face this. And I thank the Lord. May His name be glorified.
ദൈവനാമത്തിന് മഹത്വം ഉണ്ടാകട്ടെ. ഇന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഇങ്ങനെ കുടുംബമായിട്ട് ഇവിടെ നിൽക്കുവാൻ ദൈവം അനുവദിച്ചതിനായിട്ട് ഞാൻ നിങ്ങളോട് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. ആയുസ്സും ആരോഗ്യമൊക്കെ ദീർഘിപ്പിച്ചു തരുന്നത് ദൈവമാണെന്നുള്ളത് എൻ്റെ ജീവിതത്തിൽ എനിക്ക് മനസ്സിലാക്കുവാൻ തക്ക ഒന്നും സഹായിച്ചു. ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെതായിട്ടുള്ളൊരു ടൈമിംഗ് ഉണ്ട്. ആ ടൈമിങ്ങിൽ നമ്മളിവിടെ നിന്ന് പോയി വെക്കുക എന്നുള്ളത് എനിക്ക് നല്ലതുപോലെ അറിയാം. ഞാൻ എൻ്റെ ലിസിയുമായിട്ടുള്ള റിലേഷൻഷിപ്പ് 1980 ഓഗസ്റ്റ് മുതലുള്ളതാണ്. ഈ 40 വർഷത്തെ എൻ്റെ അവളുടെ ഉള്ള അസോസിയേഷനിൽ ഇതിനു മുമ്പ് നമ്മൾ കേട്ടതുപോലെ അവളുടെ സഹോദരങ്ങളോടും സഹോദരങ്ങളുടെ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളോടുമുള്ള അവളുടെ സ്നേഹത്തെക്കുറിച്ച് എനിക്ക് നല്ലപോലെ മനസ്സിലാക്കുവാൻ സാധിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. 2014 ഷോൺ ആദ്യമായിട്ടൊരു വീട് വാങ്ങിച്ചപ്പോൾ എന്നോട് അവൾ വിളിച്ച് പറഞ്ഞു, ശാന്തമാമേ എനിക്ക് ഷോണിൻ്റെ വീടൊന്ന് കാണണം. അതിനടുത്ത പ്രാവശ്യം അവൾ ടെക്സസിൽ വന്നപ്പോൾ അവളെ ഷോണിൻ്റെ വീട് കൊണ്ടുപോയി കാണിച്ചു. കഴിഞ്ഞ വ്യാഴാഴ്ച അവളെ ജീവനോടെ വന്ന് കാണണമെന്നുള്ള ആഗ്രഹം ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു. ആ രീതിയിൽ ദൈവം ഒരു വഴി അതിനുവേണ്ടി ഒരുക്കി. വിസിറ്റിംഗ് ടൈമൊക്കെ വളരെ റെസ്ട്രിക്റ്റഡ് ആണെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞെങ്കിലും ദൈവം ചില ഹൃദയങ്ങളിലൊക്കെ പ്രവർത്തിച്ച് ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് അവിടെ ചെല്ലുവാനും അവളെ കാണുവാനും സംസാരിക്കുവാനും ഞങ്ങൾക്കിടയായി. അവളെന്നോട് ഒത്തിരിയും കാര്യങ്ങൾ ആ ചുരുങ്ങിയ മിനിറ്റിനുള്ളിൽ അവളെന്നോട് ചോദിച്ചു, ശാന്തമാമയ്ക്ക് ഇപ്പോൾ എങ്ങനെ ഇരിക്കുന്നു. പിന്നെ എന്നോട് ചോദിച്ച വേറൊരു കാര്യം, ഷോൺ പിള്ളേരെ കൊണ്ട് വരുമോ, എവലിനാണോ മൂത്തത്, ലീവായാണോ മൂത്തത്, ഞാൻ പോലും അതിനെക്കുറിച്ച് വ്യക്തമായിട്ട് എനിക്ക് ധാരണയില്ല. പക്ഷെ അവൾ ഓരോരുത്തരുടെയും ആ സീക്വൻസിലെ ഓർഡറിൽ ഓർത്തിരിക്കുന്നവളാണ്. അതുകൊണ്ട് എന്നോട് ചോദിച്ചത് എവലിനാണോ മൂത്തത്, ലീവായാണോ മൂത്തത്, ഇങ്ങനെ പല കാര്യങ്ങൾ വളരെ ഓർമ്മയോടുകൂടി തന്നെ അവളെന്നോട് ചോദിച്ചു. അവളെക്കുറിച്ച് എനിക്ക് പറയാനുള്ളത് അവൾ ആത്മാക്കളെക്കുറിച്ച് ഭാരമുള്ളവളായിരുന്നു. എൻ്റെ റിലേറ്റീവ്സിനെ ഓർത്ത് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുമെന്ന് എന്നോട് പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്. അതുപോലെ അവളുടെ രോഗവിവരം അറിഞ്ഞത് മുതൽ ഞങ്ങൾ രണ്ട് കാര്യം കർത്താവിനോട് പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചത്, കർത്താവ് ഒന്നുകിൽ അവൾക്ക് പൂർണ്ണ സൗഖ്യം കൊടുക്കണം, തിരുഹിതം അതല്ല എങ്കിൽ ദൈവമേ അവൾ കിടന്ന് കഷ്ടപ്പെടരുത്. ഞങ്ങൾ രണ്ടുപേരും ഹൃദയത്തെ വളരെ ഒരുമിച്ചിരുന്ന് വളരെ സമയം പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ച ഒരു വിഷയമാണത്. അവിടെയും ദൈവം ഞങ്ങളുടെ പ്രാർത്ഥന ദൈവം കേട്ടു. 119 സങ്കീർത്തനത്തിൽ നമ്മളിങ്ങനെ വായിക്കുന്നു, നിൻ്റെ ന്യായ പ്രമാണം എൻ്റെ പ്രമോദമായിരുന്നില്ലെങ്കിൽ ഞാൻ എൻ്റെ കഷ്ടതയിൽ നശിച്ചു പോകുമായിരുന്നു. നിൻ്റെ ന്യായ പ്രമാണത്തോട് പ്രിയമുള്ളവർക്ക് മഹാസമാധാനമുണ്ട്. കർത്താവരുടെ സമാധാനമാണ് അവളുടെ ജീവിതത്തിന് ധൈര്യം പകർന്നത്. നിത്യയുടെ തുറമുഖത്ത് അവളെ കാണാമെന്നുള്ള ഉറച്ച പ്രത്യാശയോടുകൂടി ഞാൻ എൻ്റെ സാക്ഷ്യത്തിൽ നിന്ന് വിരമിക്കുന്നു.
അറ്റ് ദിസ് പോയിൻ്റ് ഐ വുഡ് ലൈക്ക് ടു എക്സ്റ്റെൻഡ് ദ കണ്ടോളൻസ് ഓഫ് അവർ അസംബ്ലി ഫ്രം ഡാളസ് മിസ്ക് ഓൺ ബിഹാഫ് ഓഫ് മിസ്കിറ്റ് ബ്രദർ അസംബ്ലി ഹു പ്രേഡ് ഫോർ ഹെർ. ഐ എക്സ്റ്റെൻഡ് ദർ കണ്ടോളൻസ് ടു ദ ഫാമിലീസ് ആൻഡ് ഓൾസോ അറ്റ് ദിസ് ടൈം ഐ വുഡ് ലൈക്ക് ടു എക്സ്റ്റെൻഡ് അവർ പ്രേയേഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് സപ്പോർട്ട് ടു ജോയ് ജിൻസ് ജോവൽ ജിൻസിൻ Lindsay and Justin and family. May the good Lord comfort all of us, and may his name be glorified.
ദൈവനാമത്തിന് നന്ദിയോടെ സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു, സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു. ലിസി സാൻചാൻ്റെ നേരെ ഇളയ സഹോദരിയാണ്. 84 കുടുംബവുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെടുവാൻ കർത്താവിനെ സഹായിച്ചത്. ഇന്നുവരെയും അവൾ എനിക്കൊരു സഹോദരിയായിട്ടായിരുന്നു, എൻ്റെ ഒരു സിസ്റ്ററിലോ ആയിട്ടല്ല, എൻ്റെ സഹോദരിയായിട്ട് എനിക്ക് വളരെ അടുത്ത ബന്ധമായിരുന്നു. സ്നേഹബന്ധം, ആത്മാർത്ഥമായ ബന്ധം, വളരെ ഇന്നസെൻ്റായിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു സ്വഭാവമായിരുന്നു അവൾ കാണുവാനായിട്ടുണ്ടായി കഴിഞ്ഞത്. ഞങ്ങൾക്കൊന്നിച്ച് പലയിടങ്ങളിൽ പോകുവാനായിട്ട് കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്. അനേക വെഡ്ഡിങ്സിന്, അതുപോലെ പ്രാർത്ഥനാ യോഗങ്ങളിൽ, ഞങ്ങളുടെ സഹോദരിമാരുടെ ആഴ്ചതോറുമുള്ള മീറ്റിങ്ങിനൊക്കെ, എല്ലാ മീറ്റിങ്ങിനും വളരെ ഉത്സാഹമാണ്. തലേ ദിവസം ചില ദിവസങ്ങൾക്ക് മുമ്പേ ഒക്കെ എന്നെ വിളിക്കും, എന്നാണ് മീറ്റിംഗ് എന്നൊക്കെ വിളിച്ച് ചോദിക്കും. മാമ ഞാൻ ഒരുങ്ങിയിരിക്കാം എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ് ഞാൻ അതിലേ ചെന്ന് വിളിച്ച് ഞങ്ങൾ ഒന്നിച്ച് പോകാറുണ്ടായിരുന്നു. എന്നോട് ചില വിളിച്ച് ചോദിക്കും, അമ്മാമ്മയ്ക്ക് ഓഫാണോ, ഞാൻ അങ്ങോട്ട് വരികയാണെന്ന് പറയും. പലപ്പോഴും മിക്കവാറും വരാറുണ്ട്. ഇടയ്ക്കൊക്കെ വന്ന് പല കാര്യങ്ങളും വിളിക്കുകയും പറയുകയും തുറന്ന് അനേക ആ സന്തോഷത്തിൻ്റെയും ദുഃഖത്തിൻ്റെയും പല പ്രശ്നങ്ങളും പ്രയാസങ്ങളും ഒക്കെ ഹൃദയം തുറന്ന് പങ്കുവെക്കുവാനായിട്ടൊക്കെ കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഏറ്റവും അവസാനമായി വന്നത് മാർച്ച് അവസാന ആഴ്ച, ഞാനും സാധിച്ചാനും കൂടെ രാവിലെ ഇരുന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്ന സമയമാണ്. ആരോ വന്ന് കഥകിന് മുട്ടുന്നതായി കേൾക്കുന്നു. ഞങ്ങൾ ചെന്ന് കഥ തുറന്നപ്പം ലിസിയാണ് സിപ്പിലോ കവറിൽ ചില വടയുമായി വന്ന് നിൽക്കുന്നു. ഞങ്ങൾ പറഞ്ഞു, ഞങ്ങളോടൊപ്പം വന്നിരുന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചു. ആ വട ഒക്കെ കൊണ്ട് വന്നതാണ്, നടക്കാനിറങ്ങിയതാണ്. നല്ല സ്നേഹം ഞാൻ ഓർക്കുകയാണ്. ആ സമയത്ത് തന്നെയല്ല, ചർച്ചിലോട്ടും ഒക്കെയും എപ്പം എന്തെല്ലാം ഏതെല്ലാം സ്പെഷ്യൽ ഒക്കേഷനുണ്ടോ, ഏതെല്ലാം വിധത്തിലുള്ള, ഇന്നലെ നാം കേട്ടതുപോലെ ഫുഡ് ഒക്കെ വട സ്പെഷ്യലാണ് കൊണ്ടുവരുവാനായിട്ട്, ആ ഒക്കെ അതിനൊക്കെയുള്ള നല്ല മനസ്സായിരുന്നു, നല്ല സ്നേഹമായിരുന്നു കാണാനായി കഴിഞ്ഞു. അതുപോലെ അവരുടെ വീട്ടിലെ പല പ്രാവശ്യം സഹോദരിമാരുടെ മീറ്റിങ്ങൊക്കെ നടക്കുമ്പോൾ ഒരിക്കൽ പോലും ഒരു സ്നാക്ക് തരാതെ വിടത്തില്ല. എന്തെങ്കിലും പല അച്ചപ്പം, അതുപോലെ പല പലഹാരങ്ങൾ ഒക്കെ ഞാൻ ഓർക്കുന്നു. മാവുണ്ട എന്തെങ്കിലും, പിന്നെ അതുപോലെ വടയൊക്കെ ഉണ്ടാക്കുമ്പോൾ എനിക്ക് ശാരമ്മക്ക് വട വളരെ ഇഷ്ടമാണ്. അത് പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് എടുത്ത് തന്നിട്ട് പറയും, ശാരന് കൊടുക്കണം എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞൊക്കെ എനിക്ക് തരാറുണ്ടായിരുന്നു. അങ്ങനെ ഓർക്കുമ്പോൾ പല കാര്യങ്ങൾ ഓർക്കുകയാണ്. അവസാനം മാർച്ച് അവസാനം ഞങ്ങളുടെ വീട്ടിൽ വന്നപ്പോഴാണ് പറഞ്ഞത്, ഏപ്രിൽ 5 ഇതുപോലെ ബയോപ്സിക്ക് കടന്നു പോകണം, ഞാൻ ജോലി ചെയ്യുന്ന ഗുഡ്സാം ഹോസ്പിറ്റലിലാണ് ചെയ്യാൻ പോകുന്നതെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു. ഏപ്രിൽ 5 ബയോപ്സിക്ക് കടന്നുപോയി. അന്ന് തന്നെ അവൾക്ക് വീട്ടിൽ വരുവാനായി ദൈവം സഹായിച്ചു. ഏപ്രിൽ 15 ശരീരത്തിന് വളരെ അസ്വസ്ഥതയുണ്ടായി. വീണ്ടും ഗുഡ്സാം ഹോസ്പിറ്റലിൽ തന്നെ അഡ്മിറ്റാകുവാനിടയായി തീർന്നു. ഞാൻ ചെന്ന് കണ്ടുടനെ എന്നോട് പറഞ്ഞതായ അമ്മാമ്മയെ ഞാൻ പാട്ടുപാടി പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചെന്നുള്ളതാണ്. അതുപോലെ എന്നോട് പറഞ്ഞതായ കാര്യം, എന്നെ കാണാനായിട്ട് ഞങ്ങളുടെ ചർച്ചിലെ സുജ റെജി ചെന്നിരുന്നു, എനിക്ക് വേണ്ട സഹായം ചെയ്തു തന്നു. അതുപോലെ കുഞ്ഞമ്മ, സാറാ കോശി, അവിടെ ആരൊക്കെ വന്ന് സഹായിച്ചോ പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചോ എന്തെല്ലാം ചെയ്തു തന്നു, അതെല്ലാം ഓർത്ത് നന്ദിയുള്ളതായ ഹൃദയം അവരെക്കുറിച്ചൊക്കെ പറയുന്നതായി ഞാൻ ഓർക്കുന്നു. ആ സമയത്ത് ഞാൻ അമ്മച്ചിയെ നാട്ടിൽ വീഡിയോ കോള് ചെയ്യാനായിട്ട് സഹായിച്ചു കൊടുത്തു. ആ സമയത്ത് അമ്മച്ചിയെ വിളിക്കുമ്പോൾ പറയുന്നത്, അമ്മച്ചി ഞാൻ സുഖമായിരിക്കുന്നു, നാളെ ഞാൻ ഡിസ്ചാർജായി പോകും, എന്നിട്ട് വീട്ടിലെ കാര്യമാണ് പറയുന്നത്. ജോയിച്ചായന, ജിൻസി മോള്, കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങൾ, ജോയൽ, എല്ലാവരുമൊക്കെ സുഖമായിരിക്കുന്നു, അവരുടെ കാര്യങ്ങളൊക്കെ നടക്കുന്നുണ്ട് എന്നൊക്കെ പറഞ്ഞ് ആ സന്തോഷത്തോടെ ഇരിക്കുന്നതായി കാണാൻ കഴിഞ്ഞു. ഡിസ്ചാർജായി പോകുന്നതായ സമയത്ത് എന്നെ വിളിച്ചു, ഞാൻ ഡിസ്ചാർജായി പോവുകയാണ്. ഞാൻ ചോദിച്ചു എങ്ങനെയുണ്ട്, അപ്പോഴെന്നോട് പറഞ്ഞു ഓൺകോളജിനെ കാണണമെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു. ഞാനും സുജയം എന്നെ വിളിച്ചിരുന്നു, സുജ ജോജി എന്നെ വിളിക്കുകയുണ്ടായി, മാമ ഞാൻ ലിസി മാമയുടെ അടുത്തോട്ട് പോവാണെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു. ഞാൻ സാറാമോളെ കൂട്ടി ഞാനവിടെ ചെന്നു. ഞാനവിടെ ചെന്നപ്പോൾ ആ എനിക്ക് കണ്ടപ്പോൾ മുമ്പ് ഞാനെങ്ങനെ കാണുന്നു അതേ രീതിയിൽ തന്നെയാണ് കാണാനായി കഴിഞ്ഞു. യാതൊരു ഭാവ വ്യത്യാസമില്ല. സന്തോഷത്തോടെ ആ അമ്മാമ്മ ഞാൻ ചോദിച്ചു, എന്തുകൊണ്ട് ഇതുവരെ അവിടെ ഒക്കെ ആയിരുന്നല്ലോ, ഫുഡൊക്കെ എടുക്കുകയും കഴിക്കുകയൊക്കെ ചെയ്യുന്നതായി കണ്ടു, യാതൊരു വ്യത്യാസവും കാണുവാനായി കഴിഞ്ഞില്ല. അതിനുശേഷം ആ ബുധനാഴ്ച ഓൺകോളേജിനെ കാണാനായിട്ട് പോയി. ഓൺകോളേജിനെ കാണാനായിട്ട് പോകുമ്പോൾ ഞാനും സാറാമോളും കൂടെ വീട്ടിലേക്ക് ചെന്നു. പിന്നെയും അവിടെ വെയിറ്റ് ചെയ്യുകയാണ്. സാറാ വിളിച്ചപ്പോൾ ഓൺകോളേജിനെ കണ്ടിട്ട് വരുന്ന വഴിയാണെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു. ഞങ്ങളവിടെ നിന്നു അല്പം കഴിഞ്ഞ ഉടനെ വന്നു. ഇറങ്ങി വന്നപ്പോഴും വളരെ സന്തോഷത്തിൽ കാണുകയാണ്. ആ വളരെ അഗ്രസീവ് ടൈപ്പാണ്, സീരിയസ് ടൈപ്പാണെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ് യാതൊന്നും തന്നെ ബാധിച്ചിരുന്നില്ല, ഒരു വ്യത്യാസവുമില്ല. അതെ, വളരെ സന്തോഷത്തോടെയൊക്കെ അകത്തേക്ക് കയറി വന്നതായി കാണുവാനായി കഴിഞ്ഞു. കർത്താവിൽ ആ ധൈര്യപ്പെട്ട് ഉറച്ചിരിക്കുന്നതായിട്ട് കാണുവാനായി കഴിയുണ്ടായി. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ ഏറ്റവും അവസാനമായി ഞാൻ കാണുന്നത് ഞാനും ഡെയ്സിയുമായി മൂണ്ടിഫെയറിൽ പോയി കാണുവാനായി കർത്താവ് സഹായിച്ചു. ചില മണിക്കൂറുകൾ മണിക്കൂറുകൾ അവളോടൊപ്പം ഇരിക്കുവാനായി ഇടയായിത്തീർന്നു. ആ സമയത്ത് ആണ് ശരീരത്തിൽ വളരെ ക്ഷീണിതയായിട്ടാണ് കാണുവാനായി കഴിഞ്ഞത്. എങ്കിലും കർത്താവിലുള്ളതായ പ്രത്യാശയും ധൈര്യവും മുറുകെ പിടിക്കുന്നതായി കാണുവാൻ സഹായിച്ചു. പാട്ട് പാടുവാനായി പറഞ്ഞപ്പോൾ എൻ്റെ ആശ്രയം യേശുവിലാവണമെന്നുള്ള പാട്ട് പാടുകയും പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുകയും ഒക്കെ ചെയ്തു. ഞങ്ങളൊക്കെ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുമ്പോൾ ആ സമയത്ത് എപ്പം പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചാലും ദൈവത്തെ മഹത്വപ്പെടുത്തുന്നതായി കാണുവാനായി കഴിയാമായിരുന്നു. ഹല്ലേലൂയ, ദൈവത്തിന് സ്തോത്രമെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ് കർത്താവിനെ മഹത്വപ്പെടുത്തുന്നതായി കാണുവാനായി കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്. യാതൊരു പരിഭവമോ ഒന്നും കാണുവാനായി കഴിഞ്ഞില്ല. ഇന്നലെയും ഞാനത് പറയുമായിരുന്നു, ഞങ്ങൾ പറയുമായിരുന്നു, മുമ്പ് എങ്ങനെ കണ്ടോ അതുപോലെ തന്നെ ആ ചിരിക്കുന്നതായ മുഖം ആണ് ഇപ്പോഴും കാണുവാനായി കഴിഞ്ഞത്. ദൈവത്തിന് നന്ദിയോടെ ഇവിടെ ജീവിതമോർത്ത് ഞാൻ ദൈവത്തെ സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു, സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. അത് അമ്മയുടെ വേർപാട് മാതാവിൻ്റെ വേർപാട് എന്തെന്നുള്ളത് 2003 ഞാൻ അനുഭവിച്ചതാണ്. ഒരു അമ്മയുടെ വേർപാടെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞത് എത്രയോ വേദനാജനകമാണെന്നുള്ളത് ഇന്നും വർഷങ്ങൾ ഇത്രയും കഴിഞ്ഞെങ്കിലും അമ്മച്ചിയെക്കുറിച്ച് ഓർക്കുമ്പോൾ ഹൃദയം വളരെ വേദനിക്കാറുണ്ട്. അറിയാതെ കണ്ണുകളൊക്കെ നിറഞ്ഞു പോകുന്നതായ അനുഭവം ഉണ്ടായിട്ടുണ്ട്. അമ്മച്ചി ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നെങ്കിൽ എന്നൊക്കെ ചിലപ്പോൾ ഓർത്തു പോയിട്ടുണ്ട്. എന്നാൽ നമുക്ക് എല്ലാം നിയന്ത്രിക്കുന്ന കർത്താവാണല്ലോ ഇന്നും നമുക്കായിട്ടുള്ളത്. മാനുഷികമായ വാക്കുകൾക്കൊന്നും ആശ്വാസം കൊടുക്കുവാനായി സാധിക്കത്തില്ല. ഒരു അമ്മയുടെ സ്ഥാനത്ത് ഒരു അമ്മയ്ക്ക് പകരമായിട്ട് അമ്മയെ റീപ്ലേസ് ചെയ്യുവാനായിട്ട് ആർക്കും കഴിയുകയില്ല. എന്നാൽ സകല ബുദ്ധിയെയും കവിയുന്ന ദൈവസമാധാനം ആശ്വസിപ്പിക്കുമെന്നുള്ളതിന് സംശയമില്ല. കർത്താവ് വരുന്ന ദിവസങ്ങളിൽ കൈക്ക് പിടിച്ച് നടത്തും. കൈവിടാത്ത കർത്താവ്, മാറാത്തവനായ കർത്താവ് കൂടെ ഉണ്ട്. അതോർത്ത് ഞാൻ ദൈവത്തെ സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു, സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. ഇതോടൊപ്പം ഞാൻ അടൂര് കുടുംബത്തിൻ്റെ ദുഃഖവും പ്രത്യാശയും അറിയിക്കുകയാണ്. ലിസി നാട്ടിലായിരുന്നപ്പോൾ തന്നെ അടൂര് ഞങ്ങളുടെ ഭവനത്തിൽ പല പ്രാവശ്യം വരുവാനായിട്ടൊക്കെ കർത്താവ് സഹായിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഞങ്ങളുടെ സഹോദരിമാർ, എൻ്റെ മൂത്ത സഹോദരി സൂസമ്മാമ ചങ്ങനാശ്ശേരിയിൽ അമ്മാമ ഇവിടെ വന്നപ്പോൾ വിവരം അറിഞ്ഞപ്പം പറയുകയായിരുന്നു. ലിസിയും ഒന്നിച്ചൊക്കെ മീറ്റിങ്ങിനൊക്കെ പോയതും ആ സൽക്കാരമൊക്കെ ഓർക്കുകയാണ്. അതുപോലെ ഷാർജായിലുള്ള അമ്മാമ കുടുംബം, അമ്മാമ പറയുകയാണ് ലിസിയുടെ ഭവനത്തിൽ ചെന്നപ്പോൾ ആ വട ഒക്കെ കഴിച്ച കാര്യമൊക്കെ എന്നോട് പറയുകയുണ്ടായി. എൻ്റെ ബ്രദറ് നിലമ്പൂര് കർത്താവിൻ്റെ വേലയിലായിരിക്കുന്നു. അവൻ്റെ ആ കുടുംബത്തിൻ്റെയും ദുഃഖവും പ്രത്യാശയും പ്രാർത്ഥനയും അറിയിക്കുന്നു. അതുപോലെ ന്യൂജേഴ്സിയിലെ മേഴ്സി ബില്ലി കുടുംബം, അവർ വന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. അവരുടെയും അനുശോചനവും പ്രത്യാശയും അറിയിക്കുകയാണ്. തുടർന്നും എല്ലാവരും ഓർത്ത് അവരൊക്കെയും പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുമെന്ന് അറിയിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഈ സമയത്ത് എൻ്റെ ജോയിയോടും ജോയൽ മോനോടും ജസ്റ്റിൻ അലീന ജിൻസിമോളോടുമായിട്ട് പറയാനുള്ളത് എൻ്റെ ഹൃദയത്തിലെ കടന്നു വന്നതായ വാക്യം 2 തിമോത്തിയോസ് 1:5 അതായിരുന്നു എൻ്റെ ഹൃദയത്തിലെ കർത്താവ് തന്നതായൊരു വാക്യം. ആ വിശ്വാസത്തെക്കുറിച്ച് തിമോത്തിയോസ് പറയുമ്പോൾ പറയുന്നു, നിങ്ങളുടെ വിശ്വാസം വലിയമ്മ ലോവീസിലും അമ്മ യുനീക്കയിലും നിങ്ങളിലും ഉണ്ടെന്ന് ഞാൻ ഉറച്ചിരിക്കുന്നു. അതെ, ആ വിശ്വാസം, വിശ്വാസത്തിന് വേണ്ടി ഉറച്ചു നിൽക്കുന്ന വല്യമ്മച്ചി, ആ വല്യമ്മച്ചി വടശ്ശേരിക്കരി അമ്മച്ചിയെ ഓർത്ത് ദൈവത്തെ സ്തുതിക്കുകയാണ്, സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുകയാണ്. കാത്തു സൂക്ഷിച്ചതായ വിശ്വാസം ഈ വാർദ്ധക്യത്തിലും വളരെ പ്രത്യാശയോടെ യേശു ക്രിസ്തുവിൽ ഉറച്ചു നിൽക്കുവാനായി കഴിഞ്ഞു. കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളും ആ ലിസിക്കും ആ കഷ്ടങ്ങളും പ്രയാസങ്ങളും ഭാരങ്ങളുടെയും എല്ലാത്തിൻ്റെയും മധ്യത്തിൽ ദൈവവിശ്വാസം തിരുവചനത്തെ മുറുകെ പിടിക്കുവാൻ അവന് വേണ്ടി ജീവിക്കുവാനായി കഴിഞ്ഞു. ആ പാത, ആ വിശ്വാസത്തിൽ നിങ്ങളും മുന്നോട്ട് പോകുവാൻ ദൈവമായ കർത്താവ് എല്ലാ കൃപയും നൽകി തന്ന് സഹായിക്കട്ടെ എന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുകയാണ്. വരുന്ന ദിവസങ്ങളിൽ ഞങ്ങളും ഞങ്ങളുടെ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളുടെ എല്ലാവരുടെയും ഞങ്ങൾ കുടുംബമായി എല്ലാവിധ ഞങ്ങളാൽ കഴിയുന്ന എല്ലാ സഹായങ്ങളും പ്രാർത്ഥനയും നിങ്ങളോടൊപ്പം ഉണ്ടായിരിക്കും. കർത്താവ് സഹായിക്കുമാറാകട്ടെ.
Praise the Lord. My name is Jacob Abraham. I am her second brother, and she is 2 years younger to me. And I noticed that at very young age, she was helping my mom in her her chores, and she started preparing food at a very young age. And I enjoyed the, her food many times. I thank God for her life. Now she is resting in peace. I was looking in many cemeteries. We can see that so and so person rest in peace, born in so and so date and died and rest in peace. It's certain that everybody is, after death, is very peaceful atmosphere. But for her, I can say that she was living also in peace. I would like to read this word from Romans 15, verse 17. For the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in Holy Spirit. Everybody in this world, after death is peace, but living in peace is that is most important, in especially in the Christian life. She went through several tough times in her life, but everybody heard that in her face, that smiley face. And she was a prayerful person, and this comforted me a lot. Now she is rest in peace, and it gives us sorrow, but we have that great hope. She is rest in peace, and we will meet her again on that glorious day. May his name be glorified. Thank you for everything. I know I had to listen to the MC. He said 30 minutes. It's almost 25 minutes has gone by. We didn't even start anything yet. We have another 4 more to go. If this is the way that we are going, I think we will be here until maybe 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock. But I know some of you have the flights that we need to catch. So I'll be very short. But the short is like maybe a couple of hours. The reason, my older brother said, he don't have that much, you know, time spent together because of the need of our house. He left our home at his early ages. But because of him, I stayed back almost a quarter century in my house just because of him. I don't forget that. At the same time, he or my family left a lot of burden on me. I was so glad to do that. But many a times I was fallen short. What I'm trying to say is that since I stayed back, I tried to do many things for my family, my siblings, and even our assembly back in Kerala, India. So when she got married in 81, I used to go to their house every week to see my sister. Until 88, I was able to do that. Then I moved over to here in 88. I didn't get a chance to see her that much, but every time when we go to India, we used to see and spend time there. When she came here, we were able to spend a lot of time together in many occasions. Yesterday we heard that she used to pray 3 times a day. As soon as she talked to the Lord, she called me to talk to me at around 5:30, 5:45, 6 o'clock in the morning. So 4 times a day, she used to call me, talk to me, and as a family, we were very close. And my wife also took that initiative to spend time together. And also, God gave me the opportunity to take her to different places in different occasions, conferences, gatherings, and also weddings. And even she was able to come with us to the funeral service of my father back in Kerala. I do remember all that good days. But I'm not here with to remember all these things. I don't have time anyway. But I'm standing here with a heavy heart. The sister is, as you heard, is older to me. First daughter in our family. Though I'm sad in earthly way, but I'm glad that she is with the Lord, the Creator, the Heavenly Father, and also joined with our earthly father. She is the first one to get that opportunity. And I'm privileged to get, she is privileged to get that opportunity. And I'm also glad that my old siblings are here to give a farewell to my sister. You heard that also. They moved to 2004 in this country, and I tried to do my best to help them in many ways, whatever way we can. But at the same time, I want to acknowledge that Joy Chayan took boldness and worked so hard to support and to do whatever that family needed to do in this country. And I'm glad that God gave him and all the dear ones to the health and all the things that they needed to bring the 3 children in God's way. And I told you that my wife, sister Shirley, is very close to my sister, and she will take a few minutes, and I don't want to take any more time. So keep each and every one of us in your prayers so that God will give us the strength. And Shandamama read the word that I wanted to read, Psalms 119, verse 165. We are here with a great peace. Maha Sandosham, Alangil, Samadhanam, Maha Samadhanam. ദൈവം തന്നതുകൊണ്ട് മാത്രമാണ് ഞാൻ നിങ്ങളുടെ മുമ്പിൽ നിൽക്കുന്നത്. പ്രിയമാതാവിനെ രാവിലെ വിളിച്ചപ്പോൾ എന്നോട് പറഞ്ഞു, ഒരു പാട്ട് ചാൾസ് ജോണിൻ്റെ പാട്ട് പാടി, ദുഃഖത്തിലും പ്രയാസത്തിലും വേദനയിലും ഈ സമാധാനം അനുഭവിപ്പാൻ ദൈവം ഇടയാക്കുന്നു. എന്നിട്ട് എബ്രായലേഖനത്തിലെ ഒരു വാക്യവും വായിച്ച് എന്നോട് രാവിലെ ആശ്വാസവാക്കുകൾ പറയുകയുണ്ടായി. പ്രിയമാതാവിനെയും അതുപോലെ ദുഃഖത്തിലായിരിക്കുന്ന അനേക പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവരെ കുറിച്ച് ഓർപ്പിക്കുവാനുണ്ട്. പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ഷേളിയുടെ ഫാമിലി ഇപ്പോൾ വിളിച്ചു പറഞ്ഞു, അതുപോലെ പ്രിയ സാമിൻ്റെ പേരൻസ് വിളിച്ച് പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്, അതുപോലെ ഷൈജ ബാബു. ഇങ്ങനെ ഒരു വലിയ ലിസ്റ്റ് എൻ്റെ മുമ്പിലുണ്ട്. എന്നാൽ because of the time limit. I don't want to take any other time, so may God's name may be glorified.
My name is Shirley Abraham. I am Lizzie Mama's sister-in-law, but we treat each other as sisters. I came to know her after our marriage in 1990. I first met her in Vadasirikara when she was 7 months pregnant with Joel. We become close after their family moved to New York in 2004. Before she got sick, she would call us every morning to check in on us to see if we ate, we drank chaya, or what is this, what days I'm working. And, you know, she want to make sure everything, you know, she want to know about us. And we used to talk and pray, encourage each other. She had a lot of difficulties and trials in her life, but she handled everything by putting her trust in the Lord Jesus and submitting it to all to him through prayer. She never complained about anything, even when she's sick. If you ask her about her pain or how is her mama, she will always say, I'm okay. She loved her husband and children, very much, and prayed for them. Every day she trained her children to fear the Lord. She didn't, another thing, she didn't drive, but she never missed a meeting. She always found a way to make it because of her love for God's word and his people. She was so thankful she could witness Justin and Aline's wedding ceremony. More recently, she was always talking about Sylvia and Sam's wedding reception and would always repeat the date, July 10th. Because she knows Justin and Aline would be visiting due to, so that date she was keep saying, you know, I'm going to see everyone. You know, she always used to say that. Due to her health, she wasn't able to make it. But I know her earnest prayer were with us that day. She was God-fearing and had a complete reliance on him. She did all that she could, what she had for God and her family. I just want to say a few words to Joy Chayan, Joel, Justin, Aline, Jinsey. I know you all feel that emptiness without her, but we pray you will know the Lord will never leave you nor forsake you. It's pleased the Lord to take her from this world full of suffering and pain to bring her into his presence. Her joyful, servant-hearted spirit will be missed greatly, but we are looking forward to seeing her on the other shore. All my siblings in India and convey their deepest condolence, and their prayers are with you. And may God's name be glorified.
ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ പിള്ളേർ നാം വാഴ്ത്തപ്പെടുമാറാകട്ടെ. ഞാൻ വിചാരിച്ചിരുന്നത് എനിക്ക് ഇങ്ങനൊരവസരം ഉണ്ടാകുകയില്ല എന്ന് വിചാരിച്ചു. മാത്രമല്ല എൻ്റെ ഭാര്യ സാലിക്ക് ഇവിടെ വന്ന് നിൽക്കുവാനുള്ള മാനസികമായ ബലമില്ലാത്തതുകൊണ്ട് അത് വേണ്ടെന്ന് വിചാരിച്ചുവെങ്കിലും ഇത് വളരെ അത്യാവശ്യമായിട്ടുള്ളൊരു കാര്യമായിരിക്കാൽ ഞാൻ ആ കാര്യം പിന്നെ സമ്മതിക്കുകയാണ് ചെയ്ത്. ബിക്കോസ് ഐ എം വെരി കൺസേൺ അബൌട്ട് ദ ടൈം ആൻഡ് ഐ ഹോപ്പ് ഐ വോണ്ട് ടേക്ക് ഓവർ ദ ടൈം ജസ്റ്റ് try my best. So I married Sally on February 1990. So that's the time Lizzie Mama was at her home, and avade ammammayude delivery odulla bandhathil ammammaye sushrushikkuvanayittayirunnu avade veettil vilichukondu vannirunnathu. Pakshengil ammamma njangale sushrushikkayirunnu cheyathu. Jolene pregnant ayirunnu mathramalla njan joli cheyidondirunna ISIP-inte aashuthriyil vechu മകൻ്റെ ഡെലിവറി നടക്കുവാനായിട്ടിടയായി തീർന്നു. ആ സന്ദർഭത്തിൽ ജോയിച്ചാൻ അവിടെ ഇല്ലായിരുന്നു എങ്കിലും എനിക്ക് അവിടെ ഒരു ആശ്വാസമായിട്ട് പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവരുടെ കൂടെ സഹായത്തിനായിട്ടിരിപ്പാൻ ദൈവനെ എടുത്തുപയോഗിച്ചു എന്നുള്ളത് ഓർത്ത് ഞാൻ ദൈവത്തെ സ്തുതിക്കുകയാണ്. അതുമുതൽ ഈ കുടുംബവുമായിട്ട് കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളുടെ വളർച്ചയിലും അവരുടെ ഇതായ ജീവിതത്തിൻ്റെ ഓരോ രംഗങ്ങളിലും ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഞാൻ എപ്പോഴും അന്വേഷിക്കുകയും അവരെ പ്രാർത്ഥനയിൽ ഓർക്കുകയും ചെയ്യുന്നു ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു എന്നുള്ളത് ഞാൻ ഒരിക്കൽ കൂടി പറയുവാനായിട്ട് താല്പര്യമുണ്ട്. എനിക്ക് അമ്മമ്മയോട് ഓർപ്പിക്കുവാൻ അമ്മമ്മയെക്കുറിച്ച് ഓർക്കുവാനായിട്ട് അനേക കാര്യങ്ങളുണ്ട്. എപ്പോഴും മെയിൻലി ഐ ജസ്റ്റ് വാണ്ട് ടു സേ വൺ തിങ് ആൻഡ് ഷീ റെസ്പെക്ട് മീ മോർ ദാൻ എൻ ബ്രദർ ആൻഡ് ഷീ റെസ്പെക്ട് മീ ആസ് എ സെർവൻറ്റ് ഓഫ് ഗാഡ് ആൻഡ് ഐ നെവർ മെനി ടൈം ഐ നോട്ടീസ് ഇവൻ ഇഫ് ഷീ ബ്രിങ് എ ടീ ആൻഡ് ഷീ വെരി റെസ്പെക്റ്റീവ്ലി ആൻഡ് ഹോൾഡിംഗ് വിത്ത് ഹാൻഡ് ആൻഡ് ഷീ സ്റ്റേ ബാക്ക് ആൻഡ് എക്സ്റ്റെൻഡ് ഹെർ ഹാൻഡ് ആൻഡ് ഓൾവേസ് ഐ ജസ്റ്റ് സീ ദ കണക്ഷൻ ആൻഡ് ഹി ഹാവ് എ ഗസ്റ്റ് ജസ്റ്റർ ഷോയിങ് ഡെമോൺസ്ട്രേറ്റിംഗ് ദാറ്റ് ഷീ റെസ്പെക്ട് മീ ആസ് എ സെർവൻറ്റ് ഓഫ് ഗാഡ് ആൻഡ് ഐ സല്യൂട്ട് അബാബ ആൻഡ് ഓൾവേസ് ഷീ എൻകറേജ് മൈ വൈഫ് ടു ട്രീറ്റ് മീ ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് ലെവൽ. ബട്ട് ഒരു ദിവസം ഞാൻ കേട്ട് എഴുന്നേറ്റ് വരുന്ന സമയത്ത് ഇടി അവൻ ഇച്ചിരി ചൂടുവെള്ളം വലിയ എന്നോട് ചോദിച്ചത് നീ ചൂടായിട്ടങ്ങ് കൊടുക്ക് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞപ്പോൾ അങ്ങനെ എപ്പോഴും ഓരോ കാര്യങ്ങളിൽ എൻകറേജ് ചെയ്യുന്നത് കേൾക്കുവാനായിട്ട് തുടങ്ങുന്നു. സോ ഐ ജസ്റ്റ് വെന്റ് ബാക്ക് ആൻഡ് ഐ ക്രൈഡ് ദ ടിയേഴ്സ് കം ത്രൂ മൈ മൈൻഡ്. ഐ സോ ദേർ ഇസ് എ സിസ്റ്റർ ടു എൻകറേജ് മൈ വൈഫ് ടു സപ്പോർട്ട് മീ എക്സ്പെഷ്യലി ഫോർ ദ സർവീസ് ഓഫ് ഗാഡ് ആൻഡ് വി മിസ് ഹെർ ഡീപ്ലി ആൻഡ് I just one more thing I want to say that I just came out like Joy Chan and a family and we started very simple humble very challenging level pray Joy Chan rendu joli cheythu kunjungale poochi pulathi I know I started with 4 rupayki joli cheythu 7 rupayki joli cheythu kunjungale karyangalil family yude support undayirengilum it's a personal challenge is there Joy Chan valare adhyam adhvanichu ningale sahayichu nammalodu kude undayirunnu dear children I just want to say a word Don't forget him and to connect with him and to talk to him and to give your all your love and he need it he expecting from you kunjangalil ninnulla oru pratheeksha njangalkkund padavidakkunnar I just want to encourage all the children to give that connection don't disconnect don't walk away even if you are move around but at the same time don't ignore we did our best what we can do So that's the end. At the end, I want to read that as Mark 14:7. And Aval Thannal Avadu Chedu. She has what she could. Amamayam kundu kariyyanthil apparamayam nilayil. Nam kettathu pole kudumbathinu vendi, sahodarangalkku vendi. Stanley Brother orpichathu pole bhaumikamayittullathaya karyangalilla. Hrudayathil ninnu. Njangale orthu prarthikkuvan, njangale orthu karuthuvan, njangale sabhaye snehikkuvan, sahodarimarude kootayimayil. കപ്പയാന്നേലും വടയാന്നേലും ഉണ്ടാക്കിക്കൊണ്ടുവന്ന് സെർവ് ചെയ്യുവാനായിട്ട് ഇല്ല എനിക്ക് ബിരിയാണി കൊടുക്കുവാനില്ല എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ് പുറമോട്ട് മാറി നിൽക്കാതെ ചെയ്ത ആയാസ ശുശ്രൂഷകളെ ഞങ്ങൾ ആദരവോടുകൂടി ഓർക്കുകയും ഞങ്ങൾക്കത് മിസ് ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്നു. ബാബ ഐ ജസ്റ്റ് വൺ വൺ മോർ സേഡ് ഓൺ ബിഹാഫ് ഓഫ് മൈ വൈഫ് എൻ്റെയും പ്രിയസാലിക്ക് കഴിഞ്ഞ ദിവസം വരുവാനും പല പ്രാവശ്യം അവിടെ അവിടങ്ങളായിട്ടും പറഞ്ഞു എനിക്കൊരിക്കൽ കൂടി ചെന്ന് അവൾക്കൊരു സ്പഞ്ച് ബാത്ത് കൊടുത്ത് അവളെ കൂടെ ആംബുലൻസ് യാത്ര ചെയ്ത് ഞാൻ അവളെ യാത്ര ചെയ്തിട്ടാണ് വന്നത് So she is very happy to give that opportunity. She God granted her to. I know you all the sisters support taking care of it. I really appreciate. But she was so privileged and we are so blessed. And that's our pleasure. And God is pleased her, my wife, to come and taking care of her one more at the last minute. And really consider us a blessing. Thank you for this opportunity. God bless you.
I praise and thank God for this time to stand before you all. Lizzie Varghese is my eldest sister, and she never failed to take care of her younger siblings. She always thought of the well-being of others before her own, whether that meant making sure that we ate or just calling to check up on us. She wanted her siblings to study well and to do good in everything, and never complained if she lacked anything. She was always content with what the Lord blessed her with. She was also kind and always had a gentle spirit. Lizzie had many sorrowful experiences in her short life. She was despised and mocked by others, but she always had a joyful heart despite the circumstances. As siblings, we used to fight often. Lizzie was a woman of few words. And if she was ever upset, she would simply listen to everything I had to say without sharing her own opinion. If she couldn't tolerate my complaining, she would hang up the phone and wouldn't speak for a while. However, she would always call back to make sure that everything was okay. I will miss her calls dearly. Even when she was sick for the last few months, she always prioritized the well-being of others. If we asked her if she has any pain, she would say no. Even if she was hurting and fought her battles alone, nearing the end of her life, she always explained that she wanted to go home. Unfortunately, this desire was never granted, but it pleased the Lord, her master, to take to her heavenly home. We will see her on the other shore. And goodbye for now.
We also send sorrow and prayers and condolences from Danny and Hannah and Mila from Dallas. And he wanted to be here, but because of they had the baby and all other things with the family that he couldn't make it. And thinking of Lisa Mama, as many have mentioned, I don't want to carry that same thought. She has such a heart of love. I just lost my niece of 27 years old in April. And she found it at a very later time. She didn't know about it. And she asked me one day, she no more lang inard. Then I said, she's no more. She felt such pain and she burst into tears. And she didn't know that. And she considered everyone as she has such a memory of all the siblings and asked about my brother and my families, everyone by name, and she knows, and she asks every time she calls me. And the connection that I have with her is, I would say, Vada connection, because she specializes in the Paripu Vada, and I specialize in Urundu Vada. So every time she calls me, first thing, she won't even say hello, she's like, Vada Yondo. Then I said, then I know who she's calling. And then every time, as many mentioned here, and she makes vada, very often, even when they have sisters meeting and everything. So I say, sometimes Suja comes back, we had a meeting, and she say, oh, we had vada. And then I call her and say, where is my vada? Then say, adalam pennunga kolla, pennunga meeting vandala kettolla. Then she makes sure the next meeting she remembers, and sometimes she packs it in a foil. It's only two vada. She'll send it with Suja, telling that, don't eat it. This is for Joji. So I come back from work and I say that, then the randu vada, how is this going to help me? And no, she says, listen, Mama said, this is for you. So even in the last week when I went to see Joy Chan, she, as Suja said, she always wanted to come home. And many times we thought, I talked to Sherry, we were going to take her to our house and, give her the care needed if she didn't get any place. And, and Sherry said, it's very hard, you can do, but it's very hard. But as Suja said, that wasn't, God was pleasing to take her home, his eternal home. So I'm happy that she has no pain, she has no suffering at this time. And I said, no, you're not going to be here. You're going to come. I want you to come back and make more vada. So that was the thing that she had, and such a heart to the Lord. And every time I remember of her, even though the difficulties, she didn't have much ability like other siblings. But she, one thing I noticed is that every opportunity she gets and everything happens in her family, either with the children or graduating, or she'll make it a point, even there is no time, she'll stand up and sing a song and share her testimony. And I know that was genuine, and she was willing to say that every opportunity she got, she will glorify God of all his goodness to her son. She didn't have much, and the love she had, and many times you think that she, she don't take care of. Every time she comes home and it's getting late, she'll say, Achanam Pumir, I have to go. I have to go make chapati. Or, and she took care of everything of his needs. And, that's what I'm thinking of her, such a loving wife and a loving mother. I just wanted, as someone mentioned here, her favorite song was "In the Ashram Ishulam." And the first, I know it is her favorite. She, every time she sings, I know that's probably the first song maybe she taught Joel. And when Joel came and he used to sing in our Sunday church meetings, he sings all the time. Every time I ask him to sing, that is the song he sings. So I know that song is dear to her and her favorite. So I just want to sing one stanza of that song. In the ashrayam ishuvila enikennu mellam avara sandavathilum endavathilum sandavathilum endavathilum sandadavum en sangeedamavan sandadavum en sangeedavan ende naalugal theernoduvil ettun swargiya thurumugathu ende naalugal theernoduvil ettun swargiya bhavanamadil andyam vareyum kathan vayal Advanikyum Jnan Vishramam in me Advanikyum Jnan Vishramam in me. I thank God for this opportunity and also send our condolences for my brother and family in India. May God give you peace and comfort these days, which we cannot offer, but we have a hope of eternal life. So God may bless you all.
This time, Daisy is not able to speak right now, so whatever she has written, I'm just going to read it first. My sister was a caring, praying, loving, dearest sister to me. In caring, she cared for not just her family, but extended family as well as the church family. She calls me in early morning to see if I get up to drink tea or coffee. Sometimes I used to get angry, but she was very loving and calls back. Calls back saying, "Mole, are you okay?" If I am awake, she would say, "I have some idli or sambar or palapam or curry, whatever her breakfast menu was." She would offer to me, and depending on work, whether she was working or off, I go around, have breakfast, hang around with her, and return home with pockets of special palapams for Charlie and Chris. Praying, she prayed for all. Sometimes when we pray, she said in details and prayed. She placed all individualized. She was also thankful to God for her many answered prayers. Loving, she loved people unconditionally. That's from my father's side. Keeps no grudges against anyone. I remember in my childhood days, I used to visit Kikuyu frequently. I'm grateful to my God and my sister's life. God allowed me to spend time with her these last 17 years when she immigrated to USA in 2004 April. She comes, stayed with us for a couple of months. Then as time went on, she moved on to apartments and she was well content in what she was. Beginning of this year in April, she had her biopsy when they noticed no bump in her neck region and was diagnosed with NHL, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. As you all heard, this Sunday by July 11th, 2021, she went home to her eternal father. Rest in peace, my dear sisters. See you on the other shore. Praise be to God. And as the youngest sibling, I got in touch with this family in 1994 after my wedding, and got much associated after they immigrated here. As she mentioned, they came and stayed with us for a few months, and after that, Jo Chan also had a very good relationship, and we used to talk. And I don't want to take much time. We all between what I mentioned, it all happened with us also. The one word which came to my mind as James Chan spoken from that Mark chapter 14, verse 8 and 9, I would like to read. She had done what she could. She is come aforehand to anoint my body to the burying. Verily I say unto you, wheresoever this gospel shall be preached throughout the whole world, this also that she has done shall be spoken of for a memorial of her. Who is giving this testimony? It is Jesus Christ who is giving this testimony about a woman. And he said she could do what she could. She did what she could. And we know that in whatever respect we see, in whatever field we see, in bringing up the children, she did her best. We all know that she didn't have a secular job in this country. She didn't go for any secular job. With what all limitations she had, she did well in training up the children, in taking them to the spiritual events, and also encouraging Joel, especially in his life. I'm sure that he's the one who will be missing the most. But God has given him the strength. Thus, I want to just give you an event which happened right after she was brought back to the nursing home. On Sunday, I went to pick up Joel. I came back. He visited her near the body. Going back, when I picked him from his home, I was instructed that not to let him know. Because of his condition, they don't want him to get reacted. So going back, I was talking to him, explaining him about that you will be not able to, in Malayalam, in fact. She is sick, and then she he says to me, Apam mummy karta pachindad to boi le. I was stunned to hear that, because it is because of the love and the way he was brought up. He realized that his mom is gone. Going back to the home, when the authorities asked him, "Hi, Joel, how are you?" He told them, "My mom is gone." God has given him the peace,
and knowledge and understanding to grasp that, and we praise God for that. We acknowledge that it is because of the work of a mom, which she did in bringing up the children, also caring for the family. She did what she could. With her limitations, she could not drive, but as we heard, she is good. She does supply these vadas and all. She makes sure that somehow she will get the ride, and she will do that. In church events, she will be ready there. For all the events, she will be coming. You want to come, she will make sure that she will get a ride somehow. And you know, even in our cottage meetings, when she comes, nobody has to ask, she will bring vada or something. That's the heart which she had. So she did what she could in her, with her all limitations which she had. And also, as Jesus Christ mentions about the testimony about that, this event which happened will be remembered all throughout. It's equal to the gospel. Wherever the gospel will be mentioned, it. So it is the desire that the work which she did in this life, it is our wish that the children and all, we should imitate, putting our whole life in giving up for the sake of Christ, for loving others and encouraging others. May the good Lord help us, and do bring the comfort and greet the condolences of my family back from Odra, my mom. She always used to ask about my mom. And also, one thing I remember, she even in her bedridden time in hospital, she remembered those who have went through grievings. She knows that Charlotte Nanan's wife is my relative, so she asked Daisy how a lovely mama is doing, even when she was in pain in hospital. So we see her her mind and hear her heart going to the grieving families. It's our love and comfort and help will be with Joy Chen and family. We'll remember in our prayers. May the good Lord help us.
Thank you, brothers and sisters, for those wonderful memories and reflections of our sister Lissy. The choir is going to sing a song, but before that, we have been also getting condolences from dear ones from different parts of the world. I would like to acknowledge at this time, and for brevity of time, I may not be able to read the whole thing, but this is from Dr. Sam Thomas from Muthumarathil House in Trivandrum. He's quoting Psalms 116:15. Joy is a very dear cousin of mine back home in Kikkayur. We spend a major part of our childhood together. A lot of good memories, laughter, and joy comes flooding into my mind at this time. I remember when Joy got married to Lissy, and Joy had to leave for work. Georgia and her mama took care of Lissy and the children. Joel, Justin, Eileen, and Jinsey, our prayers are love with you at this difficult time. We pray that you will take strength in the hope of seeing her again in heaven. May you find strength and healing from the eternal love of our Lord. We've been also getting condolences from, these are Lissy's cousins who are of the same age, from Susan, Susan and family from Dallas, Shelji from Dallas, Jolie and family from Dubai, Kurian and family from Bahrain, and Sam, Jacob and family from Houston. We also get our condolences from Matthew George, which is Shirley, is a brother from Varasaril House from New Delhi. They also send their condolences at this time. The choir is going to sing a song, and after that, the immediate family is going to give their reflections. This morning I was praying to the Lord. I said, give me one word that I could say this morning that could bring comfort to the family. There are scriptures full of wonderful words, But the word that the Lord gave me this morning for is from Isaiah 66:13. As a mother comforts a child, so will I comfort you. This is the Lord Jesus Christ himself speaking today. We miss, the family has missed a mother, a wife. As we know, the mothers are the center of every household. They make the family move. They make the family come together. They are the prayer warriors. And this family has missed that. And the Lord himself is saying he understands that. And he is going to step in. So the choir is going to sing a song. And then after that, the immediate family is going to come and give their reflections. As the choir is singing, if anybody wants to come and view and pay the respects, they can come through this side where my hand is pointing and come out this way. So the choir is going to start singing.
Yeah.
this time the immediate family is going to bring their memories and reflections of Lissy. Before that, I also want to acknowledge the condolences that we received from Raju K. Thomas of Kollat and Pastor Jacob Martin from Florida.
Hi everyone, my name is Jinsi. These past few days have made a huge impact on my heart forever. I have never felt so overwhelmingly grateful and unbelievably cared for by my family and friends, especially to my aunts and uncles. I would like to specifically mention Joji Uncle and Suji Auntie. Thank you for being my people and walking alongside me and my family from the very beginning. To all my cousins, thank you. Lydia, Sarah, Sharon, Deb, and Grace, thank you for constantly checking in on me, keeping me distracted, and overall loving me and walking with me through the most painful moments. To my Blinds to Go team, thank you for giving me the time to spend the last few moments with Mom and being so gracious throughout these past few months. And lastly, to my friends who have been loving me and showering me with constant words of encouragement and strength, thank you for being steadfast in this season. And thank you, everyone, for loving Mom and being here today. There are so many things that I could say about Mom, but one of the biggest things that stands out to me about my mom was her gentle spirit and gracious heart towards people. As many others have said, Mom never complained of any sorrow or suffering she may have been going through. Instead, she would be in constant surrender to the Lord. Mom, you've taught me how strong your gentleness can be, how courageous your tenderness is, and how sacrificial love is intended to be. You always made sure you put us before yourself in the way that you love Joel Chach, Justin, and me. You have taught me to never stop trusting in him regardless of how things may look around me. Your tenderness, steadfastness, and faithfulness taught me, molded me, and pointed me to the Lord. Thank you for giving me two older brothers who love and protect me. You have taught the three of us the importance of living a life in unity and love. Thank you for your constant prayers and support in everything that I did and said. You are my biggest supporter. From the moment that I decided to go away to school, to moving back to Rockland and starting my career, you always held my hand through life's ups and downs, demonstrating the love of our Heavenly Father, pushing me toward our Creator, even in the seasons of uncertainty and fear. Mom, when you left, you took a part of me with you. But I know you would want us to continue running the race until he calls us home. If I had it my way, there would be no goodbyes. I have never felt such deep-rooted pain. But I'm trusting that God's ways are higher than mine, and that just has to be enough. Mom, it is a blessed privilege to love and to be loved by you.
Uh-huh. just want to say thanks to my family, my extended family first, just for being here when I could not. You guys have done a lot, so I'll just give that outright. Cincy has already mentioned a lot the past couple of months how difficult it's been, but certainly how you guys have been there, you know, in and out with everything, keeping us to the best of your ability to keep us updated and seeing what other options we have before us. I'll go right into this. I just want to thank everyone for being here today for the homegoing service. On behalf of the family, we extend our sincerest thanks for all those who made the effort to have come yesterday during the wake and or today for the final farewell. I've been advised by my dad to speak on his behalf and Joel's. I think it's very hard to sum up a marital relationship of almost 40 years. There's certainly been ups and a lot of downs, but my mom has been who she is, a loving and caring soul. She held the title of home engineer, and she held it to a high standard. She looked often to make sure she pleased my dad as his loving wife. Almost all my time in the US, my dad has done two jobs to support the family. And my mom made sure that she could make that heavy burden easier by preparing all his food and helping him get to work on time. But apart from the physical, she encouraged him constantly in his daily struggles and walked with him in the toughest valleys of his life, both through prayers and emotional support. I'm glad she was there for him through it all. Even when she thought Dad might be wrong in his words or actions, she would gently nudge him to do the right thing. She would challenge him to do the right thing. And that loving and caring heart will always be remembered by him and us and reflected on fondly for the rest of our lives. I know he wishes he could have done more for Mom while she was on this earth, but I feel that will be a regret that we all have in some form. For my brother, she was once again the loveliest of moms. One of the ways she cared for him was by visiting him at his group home often. It's a 20-minute walk, so it might not seem like a hard thing, but my mother battled with pain in her legs for much of her life. So for her to have overlooked that each time is something that must be admired. The past few years I've been away from New York, so she would fill me in on how Joel Chad Jinsey has been doing, and I can't help but stand in awe of her devotion to him, certainly, and his well-being. She does it all without any thought to herself. Like an exemplary mother, she brought out the best in ourselves and gave us everything she could to make sure we thrived. You know, I certainly feel a lot of ambivalence in writing the speech today. Sometimes I can talk very honestly, and sometimes I've been told I should rein it in a little bit. But it's important to honor Mom's final moments well, and I'll do my best. There's a lot of pain in my heart, and certainly in the rest of the most beloved of Mom's family. Reflecting on her is a hard thing to do, because she went through way more hard things than I know most people have. But I'll do my best to highlight Mom's best qualities and give her a fitting goodbye. I want to apologize if I say too much or give any family secrets away. It is not my intent. It's just that my mother was a storyteller, and I'd like to think I get this partially from her. And it's not just the storytelling my mom had a penchant for, because a lot of people can tell stories. But to be real and honest with her themes in those stories, well, that was something rare. Some of the earliest memories of my mom was her confiding in me as I started to grow up in my teens. Things that she felt I should know about the world around us and the life ahead for me, certainly. While not always easy conversations, they helped me understand her better and the life that she has led thus far. And I also appreciated her care for my future. Mom, I'll remember those conversations and pass them on as you would have liked me to. And don't worry, I'm not going to tell any of those things here to these guys. They're ours alone. As you had heard, my mom was involved with the church extensively, and she deeply enjoyed the meaning and community it gave her. She knew God had placed her in this world, and she lived her life in a way that would not dishonor him. However, she was bold in how she approached her faith. Often I know people can get lost in the legalism of following one's faith, but that never stopped my mom from having fun or living life to the fullest. She's the definition of a person who is happy despite the pain in her life. I have to give Mom thanks for I had never heard how beautiful of a smile that she had or how constant that was throughout her life, because that's been said about me as well. But I guess a lot of pain that we carry helps us project a lot of the joy that God gives us. There's been untold, unspoken difficulties that my mom endured in her life. And as you've heard, she did not complain about them. At least she did not to much of the world. But those nearest to her heart, well, we got to listen to her. It would be a sin if we did not give ear to her struggles. After all, a lot of it she bore on behalf of her family. Mom, thank you for standing between me and any harsh words from the outside world, from those who might not have had the best intent for us. Thank you for telling me lovingly that I was on the righteous path when I walked faithfully, and chastising me appropriately when I would veer away. When I left for Detroit some years ago, I felt I did not have anyone in my corner. But Mom, you listened to what I said, and you believed that I could and be something that I could do and be something that I would not be able to achieve by being in the same place I was for most of my life. Thank you for trusting me and taking a chance with me. And to the audience, that was a defining mark of my mom. She was willing to hear out people that she might not have agreed with, but certainly her kids as well. She was willing to hear us out, to be willing to change her views, given adequate reasoning. An example of this is when I did a Bible camp program, and afterwards I had told her, Mom, I met a lot of people who loved the Lord genuinely, and some of them happened to be white. And I told her, Mom, I'm not dating anyone, I'm not looking into any relationships right now, but certainly if the Lord had led me to someone who was not of the Malayali faith or Malayali background, you'd have to be okay with that. And she said in Malayalam, she said, "Enikadariyam, pashe ennalum, ennalum would be nice if you was brown," you know. But she just had an understanding heart, and I will miss being able to convince her of the truth in Scripture over any of man's opinions, over even following just the tradition that we've been brought up in, but to fully lean on how God would have us love and serve others and truly honor Him. I will miss your guidance deeply in my life, and I had always hoped that I would be able to see you grow old, to give you the beautiful things you had not yet experienced. Well, I desperately yearn to gift them to you, but I know I'm not going to be able to now. I know she and I always desired to have a home of our own in New York, but that part of the American dream was perhaps never realized. A year and a half ago, I moved to Houston and married my wife, and on our one-year anniversary, we built a small place for ourselves. In the process, I had kept Mom updated, and she wanted to see pictures of the final product because she was so happy and so proud of how God had brought me and Aline so far. Brown parents often have a tough time to show that kind of pride for their children's work, but thank you for letting me know that you were in those little requests to see the pictures of the home, because I know as soon as she received it, she's probably just showing it to the aunts and uncles. And still, thank you, Mom, for reminding me to seek first the kingdom of God, just as my Apachin, my grandfather, did so many years ago. Mom, you sought His kingdom first, and you lived your life according to His calling. I promise to continue that legacy and hope to have a fraction of your prayer life. Even in her final moments, she was bridging gaps and keeping the unity in our immediate family. Dad and I had a pretty strained relationships for much of my life, as I can remember. But I think even coming back and seeing Mom in her final moments allowed me to see Dad again, be able to talk to him a little bit easier, and I think I just thank Mom so much for reconciliation, even after her death, even in her final moments. Finally, Mom, thank you so much for loving me genuinely. With the little you had, you did the most, and I'm confident God is honored by how you lived your 61 years in this earth. You know, a lot of people, while living in this world, they'll have a lot of titles, they'll have lands, they'll have money. And then, of course, you just leave all that behind, right? Well, my mom, she didn't have any of that. And she had a very short life, it seems, when Even the Bible says 70 or 80. I'm sad it didn't get to that. We were all hoping we'd have a couple more years with her, a couple more months even. I got to come here and I thought, you know, I have a week, I'll be able to remote work. You know, she might be moved into hospice. We might be able to see her pretty often, but that didn't happen the way that we were expecting or the way that we were hoping for. But Mom, thank you for showing me that my purpose is not built on accolades, but by how well I learn to love and give to others. And I hope that you are joined together with your Heavenly Father, and I hope to see you soon. Thank you again.
Just thank the Lord for that wonderful reflection and memory. Thank you, Brother Joy, Joel, Justin, Eileen, and Jinsey. You had a wonderful mother, and she leaves a wonderful legacy of sacrifice and upbringings. Her words are going to resonate in your lives on different circumstances and issues. And may the Lord Jesus Christ come himself and give you all the peace and hope at this time. At this time, I'm going to ask the nephews and nieces of Sister Lissy. They're going to be coming here and will be giving us a song.
Hello, everybody. On behalf of the cousins, I would like to share a few words about Lizzie Ante. Throughout her life, she faced countless challenges, but even then, she was able to keep her eyes on the Lord Jesus Christ. She tried her best to serve others and model the love of the Lord wherever she went. I remember once attending a prayer meeting in India, and she shared her testimony. And by the end of it, she shared this verse from Psalm 139, verse 7 to 10. It reads, "Where can I go from your spirit, or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend into heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me." To her nieces and nephew, she was known for her delicious treats and caring heart. She was a prayer warrior, and we will all miss her very much. When we heard the tragic news of the cancer, we all prayed and hoped for a miracle. However, it pleased the Lord to call her home on July 11th, 2021. We as believers in Christ have a glorious hope that we will see her one day in heaven. She was a woman who kept her eyes on the Lord, and we can see that evident in the children's lives. In the lives of my cousins, Joel, Justin, and Aline, and Jinsey. This is a testament of God's grace and the prayers of a mother who loved the Lord Jesus Christ. I ask for prayers for the difficult days ahead. I know that God is faithful, and he will supply all needs according to his glorious riches. Even in this challenging time, we can still remember the goodness of God. Thank you.
Thank you for that blessed and wonderful song. We were reminded yesterday, as Brother James Matthew spoke from the Word, John chapter 11, the Lord Jesus Christ himself says, I am the resurrection of the life. Anyone who believes in me will live, even after dying. Everyone who lives in me and believes in me will never ever die. In a difficult time like this, the only solace and comforting thoughts any of us can give to the family is hang on to Jesus as tight as possible. Hang on to the blessings and the hope that he has given. This is the only thing that gives us comfort. I know this a few years ago when my mother-in-law passed away back in India. Before the funeral, there were multiple meetings in the home. Every evening, the same words were repeated again and again, but we never thought it was boring. But those words gave peace to our hearts because they were from the Word itself. The Word of God brings peace to us. That's the only thing we can hold on. Hold on to the great people in your lives, the local assembly, your family. Hold on to them. And also we, the body of Christ, who's listening and who's here, we also have a responsibility to take care of them, check on them, because this is how we bring the Lord Jesus Christ to them, and that's the reason, that's how he's going to give them peace. As Jinsi said, she lost a piece of her. When a parents go, as dear ones go, there's a hole that gets created in the heart. That hole can be only be filled by the Lord's word and his peace, and that's the blessing that we have. This time I ask Brother Johnson John, and he's going to be coming and giving us the word of God.
Praise be to the Lord. Dear Joey brother, I think he just stepped out. And if he's listening, dear Joey brother, Joel, Justin, Aline, and Jinsi, and all the brothers and sisters of our dear sister Lissy, Raju brother, Sanguti, and Saji, Sally, Suja, Daisy, and all the families, their children. I'm actually listening in India. We, and also all the brothers and sisters, we have come together at this time to pay our final respect to your mom, wife, your sister, Amichi, your daughter, and many of us, our dear sister, and many of you, your auntie, your aunt. We have come to say goodbye until that day when our Lord returns again, until the resurrection day. So we are going to commit the body of our dear sister Lissy to the Lord and to the earth, expecting to be raised again according to the word of God. So we have come here to give her the final respect. Also, our presence here is a comfort to the family. Our words, our presence even, comfort them. We are here to pray for them. We are here to celebrate the life of our sister Lissy. A life which was touched by the gospel, by God. A life was blessed by the Lord. We read in the Word of God, precious in the sight of the Lord, the death of his saints, his holy ones, because her name is written in the book of life. There's no greater blessing than that. She is with the Lord. She is in heaven. She is rejoicing with the Lord. That is the greatest blessing a person could have. So she is blessed, precious in the sight of the Lord, the death of his saints. Precious, that word, valuable, honorable. It is used about Jesus Christ. In 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 4, it says, rejected by man, a cornerstone, rejected by man, but a choice and precious in the sight of God. That is the same word used for our sister Lizzie. She is precious in the sight of God. And we can thank the Lord for her 60 years of life, blessing her with children. And she has been a blessing to many of you, as we have been hearing. I have a connection with this family. My connection, some of you children may not know, but you know, I've been part of your family for the last many years. Was there for your children's baptism, starting with Sherry. And as recently as maybe 3-4 years ago, I had the privilege to baptize Jinsi with some of her and cousins. But our relationship goes back all the way back to the roots, all the way back to a little town in India, in Rani, a little town in Puanmala, way back. They were our immediate neighbors back in India. Immediate neighbors means only 200 feet from our house. If we walk 100 feet, then we are at the boundary of their property. If you walk another 100 feet, we are in their house. So they were their fathers, like Lissy's father, and all of you. Our dad, we called him Kunyachan Chetan. We call him we called him older brother. And Mary Yamama, your mom, very close to our family back in India. I remember Raju, I remember Sanguti, I remember Lissy. I think all of you were born in Badasarikira, but you were living in Puanmala at that time. And I think Raju is my age, almost maybe a few months older or less, I'm not sure. But I vaguely remember Lissy. She's 6 years younger than me. So I might have seen her. Then I left. You guys moved away, then settled out in Vadasarikira. But then I met her back here in the States a few years ago. And every time she sees me, she would come to me. Quietly would stand and say a few words in her quiet way and smile. But she had that connection, the family connection we had all the way back many years ago. And she would just smile, and her affection and our connection she expressed that way. And so the family is so close to me in many ways. And Joy brother, someone yesterday said he's from Pottakulam family, Pottakulam. I used to remember when I was young, 7, 8, 9, 10, I used to walk from Puanmala to Kikurur for prayer meeting, because we had a monthly prayer meeting we had in different houses, I think. Number of times I remember going to Pottakulam house, that in the roadside, there was a house, we used to have prayer meeting. Lena, I remember you when you were young, little girl with your sister Abigail, and when your mom was sick, I visited many times. My wife and I prayed for your mom, and all those memories are very vivid. But at this time, I just want to open the Word of God and share a few thoughts. One of my favorite songs, it was sang earlier this year. And one of the favorite scripture portion I would like to share in times like this also was read in the scripture reading. So let me talk about that song a little bit. That is one of my favorite hymns, one of the favorite hymns. And that was written by a man who lost all five of his children, lost all his wealth in the Great Chicago Fire. His son, only son, died earlier than that. Then 1871, the Great Chicago Fire. Then a couple of years later, maybe, all his four precious daughters were drowned in a shipwreck. In the face of losing his son and wealth and daughters, he was able to anchor his hope in the truth of the promises of the Word of God, in the hope of the Word of God. And he wrote, in the face of that tremendous loss and sorrow, "When peace like a river attended my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. Though Satan should buffet, though trials should come, but this blessed assurance control, that Christ has regarded my helpless estate and has shed his own blood for my soul." So he knew what was the lowest estate in his life would have been losing his own soul. And he said, he shed his own blood for my soul, because that would have been the lowest estate in his life. Then he wrote, "My sin, oh, the bliss of this glorious thought. My sin, not in part, but the whole, is nailed to the cross, and I bear it no more. Praise the Lord, oh, my soul." He knew the value of salvation. Sister Lizzie, your mom, your sister, is saved. She's in heaven. She's at the presence of God. She is much, much far better place than any one of us could be right now. Then Horatio Spafford wrote, "Lord, haste the day when the face shall be sight, the clouds be rolled back as a scroll, the trump shall resound and the Lord shall descend. Even so, it is well with my soul." He knew the faith will be reality someday. Something we read and speak and meditate and we understand, we see through the eyes of the faith, will become tangible, become real when the Lord comes. That is the hope I want to share this morning from the Word of God, for which I'm going to open to 1 Thessalonians, same portion of earlier read, chapter 4, verse 13 to 18. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 to 18. I will read that again. "But we do not want you to be uninformed, brethren, about those who are asleep, so that you will not grieve as do the rest who have no hope. For if ye believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who are fallen asleep in Jesus. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord will not precede those who are fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive and remain will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, so that we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words." Now, Paul, the Lord knows that we are going to grieve. We are going to go times like this. Our dear ones are going to pass away. they are going to leave. And the Lord knows that we are going to go through grief. And the Lord wants to comfort us. This message is for you. The Lord wrote this passage to comfort us. 2,000 years ago, this passage was written to comfort the Thessalonians because they were grieving the homegoing of their dear ones. Some were persecuted, killed. Some died of natural causes. But they were all waiting for the Lord to come back in their lifetime. Even Paul lived in that expectation. And when saints, believers started dying, they were confused. The Lord has not come back yet. What will happen to those who died? So the Spirit of God, the Lord, gave this passage through Paul. Even for now, as we are grieving, this passage, this message is for us. So this passage has hope, this passage is comfort. And also this hope and comfort is anchored in the gospel. But this passage is about grief. If there was no grief, then this passage would not be there. So this passage was written to diminish our grief, to alleviate our grief, to dispense our grief. It is okay to grieve. But we do not grieve as those who do not have hope. It is okay to cry. Even Jesus cried at the tomb of Lazarus. Because we read Jesus loved Martha, Mary, and Lazarus. And they loved Jesus. I know you. There's no one loves you more than your mom. Mother's love is special. No one on the face of the earth loves anybody more than their mother. And it's okay. You are not going to see her anymore. She was your greatest cheerleader. She was your encourager. She was the prayer warrior. She prayed for you. She constantly encouraged you. But she's not going to be there. You're going to miss her. It is okay to grieve. It is okay to cry. But we do not grieve as those who have no hope. So that's why Paul is giving this passage to comfort them in the midst of this grief. He says, but we do not want you to be uninformed. Uninformed. Two negatives are used to bring a positive, emphatic statement. Two negatives. Paul is saying that I want you to know. I want you to have this information. I want you to have this word of God. I want you to have this revelation. For what purpose? So that you will not grieve as those who have no hope. It's okay to grieve, but don't grieve as those who have no hope. So now he proceeds to write about the hope. So he divides the mankind into two categories. One is we who have the hope. And the other category is those who do not have the hope. Then he qualifies we, then he verses 14, for if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, so we are the one who believes the gospel. He presents the gospel in five words. Jesus died and rose again. Five words. The shortest version of the gospel is given here. If we believe, all of us believe that Jesus died and rose again. If we believe the gospel, then in the same way, how many of us believe that Jesus died 2,000 years ago on the cross of Calvary? We all believe that. How many of us believe that he rose from the dead? We believe that. If you didn't believe that, you cannot be a Christian. Because if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is God or Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. So our Christian journey started with believing in the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And our glorified life will start with our own resurrection. Because when the Lord comes, those who died in Christ will rise first. So the gospel is that God became man. Why? To save us, to bring us to glory. God, the Creator, entered creation. The eternal entered time. The infinite has become finite. And the invisible has become visible for the purpose of taking our sins and sorrows. And He made them His very own. He carried them to Calvary's cross and He died there. He took all our sins, and He died for our sins. That's why He died. And He rose from the dead. He given us hope beyond death and grave. And that is the gospel. Now Paul is laying this gospel as the foundation on which he's going to build this hope. If there was no hope, gospel, then there's no hope. If there was no gospel, Jesus will not come back. If there was no gospel, there's no trumpet sound, no voice of the angels, no shout. If there was no gospel, no resurrection of the dead. If there was no gospel, no transformation of the living. If there was no gospel, no rapture. If there was no gospel, no reunion. But because of the gospel, Jesus is going to come back. Because of the gospel, the dead in Christ will rise again. Because of the gospel, we who are alive, if Jesus comes, if He comes today, right now, we will be transformed. Because of the gospel, we will be renewed. And because of the gospel, there will be rapture, a great grand reunion. And Paul says, comfort one another with these words. So the gospel is the foundation on which the hope is built. And from the hope, we get comfort. And that is the word I wanted to share with you this morning. Because of the gospel, we have hope. And because of the hope, we have comfort. May the Lord comfort your heart with these precious words. God bless you. We'll keep you in our prayers. May His name be glorified.
Thank you, Brother Johnson, for those wonderful thoughts and the blessed hope that we have. We know that the Lord is going to be coming. And what we read here is that there is going to be a shout. The same shout that Lazarus heard. Lazarus, come out. That's what Lissy is going to be here. Lissy, rise up. And the archangel is going to come. Come hither. And the trumpet of the Lord is going to be sounded, and she is going to be rising up. This is the power of resurrection in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. May these words help us, as we read, to comfort each other. At this time, I'm going to ask Saji Abraham to come and give the vote of thanks. And follow that, Brother James Matthew will be coming and closing the session in prayer and benediction. And after that, we will have some announcements in terms of the second part of the service.
Good morning, and praise the Lord. As you all know, that I'm here with a heavy heart. But at the same time, I have certain responsibilities vested on me. So I had to use that time wisely too. People from various places, I can say from north to south, east to west, people from Kerala in US, as well as Gulf countries and New Zealand and other places are calling me and letting us know that they are praying for us, praying for the services, That is the only reason why we are able to hold a service like this in this fashion. I want to thank the Lord for the blessings and the provisions and the providence given for us to hold this service in a godly manner. This will not be possible without His favor. So I really thank the Lord for all the provisions that God given to us. I also wanted to acknowledge the RBA family. As you all heard that also, she's been our part of the assembly for the past 17 years. Every single meeting, every event, everything that she's part of our assembly, and we acknowledge the assembly took part and support us in many ways. I know without our request or our phone call, some of our dear ones are in the assembly this morning making sure everything is correct, everything is right, everything is in order. I don't want to mention any of the names, but I know, and if I know, definitely God knows, and God will answer, and God will reward you, each and everyone who worked, helped, supported, and prayed for anything that you did for us on behalf of our family. I want to thank each and every member of the assembly. May God reward you, help you, and also provide you all the blessing and in the coming days as well. And I want to thank Brother Johnson, John. You heard from himself. He's not far from our neighborhood house in back in Kerala. So I really thank the Lord for giving the opportunity to bring our God's servant in the midst of us to help us with the God's word. That is the only word that we can find comfort. We may say something that will not give us the comfort and peace. But the God's word, we heard it from a few days ago, this is the God who created the heaven and earth. He is the one who gives us the support, help, and also comfort at this difficult time. So I want to thank the Lord and also at the same time to the servant of God to come and bring the word to us and also helping us in the service here as well. I also wanted to thank Brother Shalin. He's not a stranger. You know, anything that you needed, every event or anything that we have as an assembly, as a family, he is there. You don't need an invitation. You don't need to ask him. He's right there. I heard that yesterday morning on. He is with us. I really thank the Lord. And also, we as an assembly appreciate your effort and your support and the services that you're doing for us as well as for the Lord's name. So we acknowledge that you thank the Lord for him and his family and all the dear ones. I have many, many lists in my mind. In the list, the hospital, you heard that April 5th, she went for the diagnosis. After that, she was not. April 4th, she was in our house too. And 5th, she went for the biopsy. And after that, she went to the hospital in Good Sam and also spent time in the Montefiore Hospital. Many of the doctors, nurses, and others helped in many ways and to try to do many things to give her the care and also support. And I acknowledge each and everyone, especially Bekurjan's two sisters, Panamama, Eliyama Matthew, and also Sister Sally. They were very helpful and very supportive and do many things for us. We really thank to you, and also we remember you in our prayers as well. May God help you and reward you accordingly. After 2 days, in the past, July 9th, 10th, and 11th. She spent her last time in this world in the nursing home, North End Manor Nursing Home. We thank the Lord for the provisions, and we acknowledge and we're thankful to the authorities and the nurses and all the dear ones in that North End Manor Nursing Home as well. We want to thank the Lord for providing the media, Soji, and the team. Whenever I called, I never met him or anything, but he, since ever I called, they were very gracious, very thankful, and very helpful in many ways. We will try our best to do anything that you needed since that they've been here, and we're thankful to each and every one as the team. Then may God reward you accordingly. And I mentioned earlier, I have a list that I need to go through. All my siblings were here. I mentioned that earlier. And we want to thank the Lord, especially Rai Chan and family. They were here ever since they came. They took over, and they were very helpful in any way. And we thank the Lord for that. And also Joji and Suja we mentioned. And also all the other dear ones who supported. I don't want to miss one thing. Joy brother and family, Jijo and family, we cannot say thanks to them. I don't know how to give thanks to them, because they've been a blessing for us. We really thank the Lord for the ways that they brought us in the midst of us for the last few days. As you heard from a few days ago, Joy brother was on the way to Atlanta, but God held him and hold him back, and he was in the back in us, and we thank the Lord for all that. And many dear ones from India called: Rajan Kalloth, Binu Samuel, Siti Jonikuti, Manichan Evangelist from Chittar, and Pastor Jacob Matthew from Florida. Many of our cousins from Gulf countries I mentioned earlier, many of them are there. We thank the Lord for them, and also we appreciate your support and help in our way. God help you in the coming days. And Gigi Matthew from Houston, the Mesquite Brethren Assembly, RB Assembly, and Kikorur Assembly, Vadasherikere Assembly, all these dear ones are praying and supporting in many ways as possible. So we acknowledge them, and we're thankful to each and every one of them. And many of the dear ones, especially Biju from Texas, traveled all the way from Texas to here to support us. And we really appreciate, and we're thankful to you, and may God help you, and many other dear ones. I don't want to take any other time. I know the time is valuable, and we want to move on. So we thank each and everyone who took the time to come to our house for the last 3-4 days. People are constantly calling, coming, and helping us in many ways. Some of you are taken off, and with the short notice, we thank you from the bottom of our heart for all the support, all the help that you did on behalf of our family, Joy Chan's, and all the dear ones. We want to thank each and every one. Again, may God help each and every one of us in the coming days as well. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Saji. At this time, Brother James Matthew is going to come and close his session in prayer with a benediction. Just as one announcement is that after the interment service, the family requests your presence for lunch at Rockland Believers Assembly at 1 Old Valley Cottage. What's this? So they like your presence for lunch. Saji also wanted to add the family's gratitude to the funeral home, Michael J. Higgins, the service, this hall that we are in, for their support, the cooperation, all the love and help they have been providing the family. We want to acknowledge that also. So after the prayer, the benediction, the dear funeral director of this place is going to come and give us the details on how we're going to leave from here. And after that, the choir is going to be
singing, and you could pay your final respect. At the end, the family stays and they will pay their final respects to our sister Lissy's mortal body here. So at this time, I ask James Matthew to come and pray.
Let us pray. Gracious Lord, loving Heavenly Father, we as thy children have been sitting in thy presence from morning, and you have been so good to us, O Lord. You have been speaking to us as we gathered here to give respect to our dear sister as she to her homegoing. You have been good to her for the past so many years, and you have given her the privilege of becoming thy child. And in your right time, you have called her home, and she is now with her Savior Jesus Christ in the most loving and benevolent place. We, as the relatives and loved ones of the dear sister, though we are sitting here with heavy heart, you have been comforting us, especially you have been extending your comfort to the dear family members and all of us, Lord. And we pray that you continue to extend your comforting word to them, so that in the days to come, they will be able to praise you, God. As we are departing from here, help us to be with us and help us to praise you and give you glory, Lord, in all the rest of our life. We commit everything in the most precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Let the love of our Heavenly Father and the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each one of us, especially with the family, from now and forevermore. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we're going to prepare to take leave for the cemetery. If we could ask all those from the back room, if you'd like to come up, pay a very quick last respect, and then return to your cars. We do have a set time of arrival at the cemetery, so we do have to get going. The police are outside to help us. So again, if we could start with the back room, if you'd like to come up, pay one final respect, and then return to your cars, okay?
Yeah.
Thank you. ലോകത്തെ ഞാൻ ഓർക്കുന്നില്ല, കഷ്ടനഷ്ടമോർക്കുന്നില്ല. എപ്പോഴെൻ്റെ കർത്താവിനെ ഒന്നു കാണാമെന്നേയുള്ളൂ. ദുഃഖത്തിൻ്റെ പാനപാത്രം കർത്താവിൻ്റെ കയ്യിൽ തന്നാൽ സന്തോഷത്തോടതു വാങ്ങി ഹല്ലേലൂയ പാടിയിടും ഞാൻ.
ഞാൻ മാത്രമായി വിട ചൊല്ലി തിരിയുമ്പോൾ ഓർക്കുമോ നിങ്ങളെ സോദരരെ, മറക്കുമോ നിങ്ങളെ സ്നേഹിതരെ. ഓർമ്മകൾ മാത്രമായി വിടച്ചൊല്ലി പിരിയുമ്പോൾ ഓർക്കുമോ നിങ്ങളെ സോദരരെ, മറക്കുമോ നിങ്ങളെ സ്നേഹിതരെ. കണ്ണീർ കടലിനും അപ്പുറമുള്ളൊരു ശാശ്വത തീരത്ത് കണ്ടുമുട്ടാം. ഓർമ്മകൾ മാത്രമായി വിടച്ചൊല്ലി പിരിയുമ്പോൾ ഓർക്കുമോ നിങ്ങളെ സോദരരെ, മറക്കുമോ നിങ്ങളെ സ്നേഹിതരെ. ജീവിതം ഒരു തൃണം പോലെ ക്ഷണികമെന്നോർക്കണമിനിയെങ്കിലും, മാനവ ജീവിതം ഒരു തൃണം പോലെ ക്ഷണികമെന്നോർക്കണമിനിയെങ്കിലും, വയലിലെ പൂ പോലെ കൊഴിഞ്ഞു പോകാം പിന്നെ തൽസ്ഥാനമതിനെ വിസ്മരിക്കാം. വയലിലെ പൂ പോലെ കൊഴിഞ്ഞു പോകാം പിന്നെ തൽസ്ഥാനമതിനെ വിസ്മരിക്കാം. സ്വപ്നങ്ങളേറെ നെയ്യരുതേ സമ്പാദ്യമോഹത്തിൽ വീഴരുതേ, ഓർമ്മകൾ മാത്രമായി വിടച്ചൊല്ലി പിരിയുമ്പോൾ ഓർക്കുമോ നിങ്ങളെ സോദരരെ, മറക്കുമോ നിങ്ങളെ സ്നേഹിതരെ. ബന്ധങ്ങളും നാമരൂപങ്ങളും ഭൂവിതിൽ മാത്രമേ കാണുമതുള്ളൂ. സ്നേഹബന്ധങ്ങളും നാമരൂപങ്ങളും ഭൂവിതിൽ മാത്രമേ മറുള്ളൂ. ഇന്നു ഞാൻ നാളെ നീ എന്നതാവാം സ്നേഹ. രക്തബന്ധങ്ങൾ പോലും മറഞ്ഞു പോകാം. ഇന്നു ഞാൻ നാളെ നീ എന്നതാവാം സ്നേഹ. രക്തബന്ധങ്ങൾ പോലും മറഞ്ഞു പോകാം. സ്വപ്നങ്ങളേറെ നെയ്യരുതേ മനുഷ്യ. സമ്പാദ്യമോഹത്തിൽ വീഴരുതേ, ഓർമ്മകൾ മാത്രമായി വിടച്ചൊല്ലി പിരിയുമ്പോൾ ഓർക്കുമോ നിങ്ങളെന്നെ. അപ്പുറമുള്ളൊരു ശാശ്വത തീരത്ത് കണ്ടുമുട്ടാം. ഓർമ്മകൾ മാത്രമായി വിട ചൊല്ലി പിരിയുമ്പോൾ ഓർക്കുമോ നിങ്ങളെ സോദരരെ, മറക്കുമോ നിങ്ങളെ സ്നേഹിതരെ.
ആകെയൽപ്പ നേരം മാത്രം എൻ്റെ യാത്ര തീരുവാൻ ആകെ സമയമാം രഥത്തിൽ ഞാൻ സ്വർഗയാത്ര ചെയ്യുന്നു എൻ സ്വദേശം കാൺമതിനായി ഞാൻ തനിയെ പോകുന്നു രാത്രിയിൽ ഞാൻ ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ കൈകളിൽ ഉറങ്ങുന്നു അപ്പോഴും എൻ രഥത്തിൻ്റെ ചക്രം മുൻപോടുന്നു സമയമാം രഥത്തിൽ ഞാൻ സ്വർഗയാത്ര ചെയ്യുന്നു സ്വദേശം കാൺമതിനായി ഞാൻ തനിയെ പോകുന്നു രാവിലെ ഞാൻ ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ കൈകളിൽ മനസ്സിൻ്റെ സ്വപ്നം മുൻപോത്തോടുന്നു സമയമാം രഥത്തിൽ ഞാൻ സ്വർഗയാത്ര ചെയ്യുന്നു എൻ സ്വദേശം കാൺമതിനായി ഞാൻ തനിയെ പോകുന്നു പ്രപഞ്ച സുഖം തേടാൻ ഇപ്പോഴല്ല സമയം എൻ സ്വദേശത്ത് ചെല്ലേണം യേശുവിനെ കാണണം സമയമാം രഥത്തിൽ ഞാൻ സ്വർഗയാത്ര ചെയ്യുന്നു സ്വദേശം കാൺമതിനായി ഞാൻ തനിയെ പോകുന്നു സമയമാം രഥത്തിൽ ഞാൻ സ്വർഗയാത്ര ചെയ്യുന്നു എൻ സ്വദേശം കാൺമതിനായി ഞാൻ തനിയെ പോകുന്നു എൻ്റെ കാത്തല്ലോ ദൈവമേ, ഒന്നും ചെയ്തില്ല ഞാനീ ഭൂവിൽ, നിന്റെ നന്മകൾ പൊത്തതുപോ, ഒന്നും ചെയ്തില്ല ഞാനീ ഭൂവിൽ, നിന്റെ നന്മകൾ പൊ. ദുഃഖത്തിൻ്റെ പാനപാത്രം കർത്താവിൻ്റെ കയ്യിൽ തന്നാൽ, സന്തോഷത്തോടതു വാങ്ങി ഹല്ലേലൂയ പാടിയിടും ഞാൻ. ദുഃഖത്തിൻ്റെ പാനപാത്രം കർത്താവിൻ്റെ കയ്യിൽ തന്നാൽ, സന്തോഷത്തോടതു വാങ്ങി ഹല്ലേലൂയ പാടിയിടും ഞാൻ. ദോഷമായിട്ടൊന്നുമെന്നോടെ താതൻ ചെയ്യയില്ല, എന്നെ അവനടിച്ചാലും അവൻ എന്നെ സ്നേഹിക്കുന്നു. കഷ്ടനഷ്ടം ഏറി വന്നാൽ ഭാഗ്യവാനായി തീരുന്നു ഞാൻ, കഷ്ടമേറ്റ കർത്താവോടു കൂട്ടാളിയായി തീരുന്നു ഞാൻ. സൗഖ്യമെന്തു തരും ആത്മക്ലേശമതിൻ ഫലം, സൗഭാഗ്യമുള്ള ആത്മജീവൻ കഷ്ടതയാൽ വർദ്ധിക്കുന്നു. ജീവനത്തിൻ വമ്പു വേണ്ട, കാഴ്ചയുടെ ശോഭ വേണ്ട, കൂടാരത്തിൻ മൂടി പോലെ ക്രൂശിൻ നീണം മാത്രം മതി. േരും കേരൂവികൾ കൂടാരം ഭക്തനായുമുണ്ടവിടെ ഭക്തന്മാരാം സഹോദര വിളക്കൂ പോൽ കൂടെയുണ്ട് പ്രാർത്ഥനയിൻ ധൂപമുണ്ട് മേശമേലെ ത്തിലെൻ്റെ മുൻപിൽ യേശുവിനെ കാണുന്നു ഞാൻ യാഗപീഠമാവനത്രേ എന്നും എൻ്റെ രക്ഷയവൻ ദിനം തോറും പുതുക്കുന്ന ശക്തി എന്നിൽ പകരുവാൻ സ്വച്ഛ ജലം വെച്ചിട്ടുള്ള പിച്ചള തൊട്ടിയുണ്ട് ലോകത്തെ ഞാൻ ഓർക്കുന്നില്ല കഷ്ടനഷ്ടമോർക്കുന്നില്ല എപ്പോഴെൻ്റെ കർത്താവിനെ ഒന്നു കാണാമെന്നേയുള്ളൂ ദുഃഖത്തിൻ്റെ പാനപാത്രം കർത്താവിൻ്റെ കയ്യിൽ തന്നാൽ സന്തോഷത്തോടതു വാങ്ങി ഹല്ലേലൂയ പാടിയിടും ഞാൻ
ഭംഗേറിയാ Together in the presence of God around this grave to commit the body of our dear sister Lizzie Verghese to the Lord and to the earth, expecting to be raised again according to his precious word on the resurrection day. So with that hope in our heart, let us start this service, and we're going to start with an opening prayer, and our brother is going to open in a word.
ഞങ്ങളുടെ കർത്താവേ, അങ്ങ് ശാശ്വതമായും ഞങ്ങളുടെ ദൈവമായിരിക്കാനുള്ള നിങ്ങളുടെ സ്തോത്രം. തലമുറ തലമുറയായി അങ്ങ് ഞങ്ങളെ പരിപാലിച്ചു, ഞങ്ങളെ കാത്തു പരിപാലിച്ച് വഴി നടത്തുന്നവർക്കായിട്ട് നിങ്ങളുടെ സ്തോത്രം. പൊന്നുപിതാവേ, പ്രിയ സഹോദരിയുടെ ഭൗതിക ശരീരം ഞങ്ങൾ മണ്ണിലേൽപ്പിക്കുന്ന ഈ സമയത്ത് കർത്താവേ, ഞങ്ങൾ തനിക്കായെന്ന നിങ്ങളുടെ സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. നിന്റെ മകളെ ഭൂമിയിൽ ജീവിപ്പാന് ഭാര്യയായി, അമ്മയായി, ഒരു സഹോദരിയായി തനിക്ക് വേണ്ട കർമ്മങ്ങളെല്ലാം ചെയ്യുവാൻ കർത്താവ് കൊടുത്ത് കൃപകൾക്കായിട്ട് നന്ദിയോടെ സ്തോത്രം. മാതൃകയുള്ളൊരു നല്ല ക്രിസ്തീയ ജീവിതം താൻ കാഴ്ചവെച്ച വലിയ കൃപകൾക്കായിട്ട് നന്ദിയോടെ സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. ആ നല്ല ജീവിതത്തെ പകർത്തുവാൻ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഓരോരുത്തർക്കും അവിടെ നിന്ന് കൃപ തരയണം എന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ സ്നേഹത്തോടെ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. ഇപ്പോൾ കർത്താവെ, ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രിയ കുടുംബത്തെയും ഞങ്ങളെ ഓരോരുത്തരെയും അവിടുത്തെ കരങ്ങളിലേക്ക് സമർപ്പിക്കുന്നു. സകല ബുദ്ധിയെയും കഴിയുന്ന ദിവ്യ സമാധാനത്താൽ ഞങ്ങൾ ഹൃദയങ്ങളെ ഭരിക്കുകയും അവിടുന്ന് അനുഗ്രഹിക്കുകയും ചെയ്യുമാറാകണമെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. സമസ്ത കാര്യങ്ങളും ശുശ്രൂഷയും അവിടുത്തെ കരങ്ങളിലേക്ക് സമർപ്പിക്കട്ടെ. അവിടുന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥന ഘടനായ സ്തോത്രം കർത്താവായ യേശു ക്രിസ്തുവിന്റെ നാമത്തിൽ തന്നെ.
So we are going to read a portion of the scripture, then make a few comments, then we will sing a song, then we'll pray, then we'll close the service. So we are going to read 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 50 to 58. 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 50 to 58. Now I say this, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we will be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For this perishable must put on imperishable, and this mortal must put on immortality. But when this perishable will have put on imperishable, and this mortal will have put on immortality, then will come about the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your toil is not in vain in the Lord. So this chapter is about resurrection. 58 verses written by Apostle Paul to prove the resurrection. This is the greatest treatise on the subject of resurrection. But this is not about the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. It is written, 58 verses were written to prove or establish the fact of our resurrection, the believer's resurrection. That is established on the foundation of the Lord's resurrection. So the first 11 verses is about the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's the foundation. So verse 12 says, if now Christ is preached that he has been raised from the dead, how do some of you say that there is no resurrection of the dead? So in order to answer that question, Paul wrote the rest of the chapter to prove that our bodies will be resurrected for sure, 100% sure. So the theme of this passage is victory. Three times we read that. Death is swallowed up in victory. Then, oh death, where is your victory? Then thanks be to God who gives us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. So victory is the theme of this passage, but the victory comes with a change. So change is part. The mortal remaining, that's what we call mortal, and that will become immortal, never to die. So this change is coming. That is part of the victory. When is this change coming? When the Lord comes. And that change comes in a moment. We don't even know. Maybe before we finish this service, the Lord may come, we will be changed. And your mom would be risen from the dead, and we will all be changed. We'll all be together. That is the message the Lord is saying. So the change is coming. The change comes when the Lord comes. And the change comes according to the word of God. It's quoted Isaiah and Messiah according to the word of God. And the change comes with a celebration. Because those who are in the grave would come out of the grave and say, oh grave, where is your victory? You thought you had me, but I'm alive. And we who are alive, death is not going to touch us, so we are going to say, oh death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and Christ took our sting. So we will never die. He died with death. We will sleep, or we will be alive when he comes. So that is the hope we have. So the victory is coming. Change is part of the victory. Change comes when the Lord comes. Change comes according to the word of God. Change comes with a celebration. Because of that, let us thank the Lord. Thanks be to God who has given us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. With this beautiful thought, this blessed thought in our hearts, let us commit the body of our dear sister, your mom, your eyes, to the Lord and to the earth. We have to earth, dust to dust, expecting to be raised again according to his precious word. So that with that hope in our heart, let's say goodbye until that resurrection day.
രക്ഷപ്പെട്ടോരക്കരെ കൂടിയാകാശി വിളിക്കും നേരം കാണുമെന് പേരും പേർ വിളിക്കും നേരം കാണും പേർ വിളിക്കും നേരം കാണും പേർ വിളിക്കും നേരം കാണും പേർ വിളിക്കും നേരം കാണുമെന് പേരും
ക്രിസ്തനിൽ നിദ്ര കൊണ്ടോരി ശോഭിതം ക്രിസ്തൻ ശോഭന
Father, we are so thankful to you for all your mercies in our life. We thank you, Father, for giving us your Son, your only Son, our Savior, our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we might be your children. We thank you and we bless you. Bless the Lord, bless the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who, according to his great mercy, has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to obtain an inheritance which will never destroy, decay, or fade away, kept in heaven for us, who are protected by the power of God. For a day it will be revealed when our Lord Jesus Christ comes again. Even in this we greatly rejoice, even though for a short time we have been distressed and grieved and by the separation and other trials in our lives. We pray for your mercy upon each one of us. We thank you for our sister Lindsay. We thank you for your blessing upon her. We thank you for the life you gave her. Thank you for the family you gave her. Thank you for Joy's brother. Thank you for each one of the children, Joel and Justin and Aline and Jency. We pray for them. We pray that you comfort their heart, Lord. We pray that you comfort our brother's heart. That is his partner in life you gave for many years, Lord. It is a great separation. Somebody who was proud of you all these years. Lord, you give him the comfort and the grace and the strength he needs at this time. Pray for the children that you comfort their heart. Pray for the siblings and nephews and nieces and others who are grieving at this time. Her mom, pray that you comfort each one of them. We thank you for the hope we have in Christ Jesus. With that hope in our heart, we commit the body of our dear sister to you, O Lord, and to the earth. Bless to earth, bless to God, expecting to be raised again on the resurrection day, that beautiful day when the trumpet will sound and the Lord will descend, and we read, the dead in Christ will rise first, and we will be transformed, and we will all be together with you in glory. Thank you, thank you, thank you for the hope. With that hope in our hearts, we commit this glory to you, Lord. We ask this in the name of our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. May the love of God the Father, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion, the comfort of God the Holy Spirit be with each one of us and all the saints everywhere, now and forevermore. Amen. Thanks be to God who has given us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Kartavaya Yesu Kristu Muhandaram, namakku jayam nalguna devathine
stotram.
Stotram. Okay, so the service is ended here. So any further instructions, if anybody has? Okay.
Somebody wants to thank each and everyone for your presence and your prayers.
and your presence have meant a lot to them, that gives us peace and comfort as we are going to submit our sister's mortal body to the continue to pray for the family. We also request your fellowship at Assembly Hall after this.
One Old Lake Road.
What, yeah, One Old Lake Road, Valley Cottage, New York. So they would love to have your presence there. Thank you. God bless you.
Don't you reach given a single flower, you welcome.
ഹല്ലേലൂയാ പാടിയിടും ഞാൻ, ദുഃഖത്തിൻ്റെ പാനപാത്രം കർത്താവിൻ്റെ കയ്യിൽ തന്നാൽ, സന്തോഷത്തോടതു വാങ്ങി ഹല്ലേലൂയാ പാടിയിടും ഞാൻ. ദോഷമായിട്ടൊന്നുമെന്നോടെ താതൻ ചെയ്യേയര നാഴിക മാത്രം ഈ ഉടുപ്പു മാറ്റുവാൻ സമയമാം. രഥത്തിൽ ഞാൻ സ്വർഗയാത്ര ചെയ്യുന്നു, എൻ സ്വദേശം ആൺമതിനായി ഞാൻ തനിയെ പോകുന്നു. രാത്രിയിൽ ഞാൻ ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ കൈകളിൽ ഉറങ്ങുന്നു, അപ്പോഴുമെൻ രഥത്തിൻ്റെ ചക്രം മുൻപോടുന്നു. സമയമാം രഥത്തിൽ ഞാൻ സ്വർഗയാത്ര ചെയ്യുന്നു, എൻ സ്വദേശം കാൺമതിനായി ഞാൻ തനിയെ പോകുന്നു. രാവിലെ ഞാൻ ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ കൈകളിൽ ഉണരുന്നു, അപ്പോഴുമെൻ മനസ്സിൻ്റെ സ്വപ്നം മുൻപോത്തോടുന്നു. സമയമാം രഥത്തിൽ ഞാൻ സ്വർഗയാത്ര ചെയ്യുന്നു, സ്വദേശം കാൺമതിനായി ഞാൻ തനിയെ പോകുന്നു. ഈ പ്രപഞ്ച സുഖം തേടാൻ ഇപ്പോഴല്ല സമയം, എൻ സ്വദേശത്ത് ചെല്ലേണം, യേശുവിനെ കാണണം. സമയമാം രഥത്തിൽ ഞാൻ സ്വർഗയാത്ര ചെയ്യുന്നു, എൻ സ്വദേശം കാൺമതിനായി ഞാൻ തനിയെ പോകുന്നു. സമയമാം രഥത്തിൽ ഞാൻ സ്വർഗയാത്ര ചെയ്യുന്നു, എൻ സ്വദേശം കാൺമതിനായി ഞാൻ തനിയെ പോകുന്നു. വിദേശിയായി പാർത്ത ദേശം സ്വന്ത നാട്ടിൽ സ്വന്ത വീട്ടിൽ നിത്യകാലം വാഴുവാൻ സ്വന്ത നാട്ടിൽ സ്വന്ത വീട്ടിൽ നിത്യകാലം വാഴുവാൻ ചെയ്തില്ല ഞാനീ ഭൂവിൽ നിന്റെ നന്മകൾ പൊത്തതുപോന്നും ചെയ്തില്ല ഞാനീ ഭൂവിൽ നിന്റെ നന്മകൾ പൊത്തതുപോ വിട്ടുപോകുന്നു ഞാനീ ദേശം അന്യനായി പരദേശിയായി പാർത്ത ദേശം സ്വന്ത നാട്ടിൽ സ്വന്ത വീട്ടിൽ നിത്യകാലം ഭാഗ്യവാന്മാരവർ നിശ്ചയം കർത്താവിൽ മരിക്കുന്ന മർത്യ ഭാഗ്യവാന്മാരവർ നിശ്ചയം ചെന്നു ചേരും വേഗമവ
കാഴ്ച